हेलो अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम टू अनदर एपिसोड ऑफ द पाकिस्तान एक्सपीरियंस। मैं डोनाल्ड ग्लवर को देखता था और मैं सोचता था कि एक इंसान इतनी सारी चीज़ें कैसे करता है। एंड देन आई वाज लाइक, ये कोई एलियन होगा, हमारे यहाँ तो ऐसे लोग नहीं होते। एंड आई फेल्ट गुड अबाउट माई सेल्फ कि ठीक है, मैं दो तीन चीज़ें कर रहा हूँ। बट देन आई हैड दी अनफॉर्चुनेट एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ इनकाउंटरिंग राफत मज़र, जो एक रिसर्चर भी करते हैं, तो रिसर्च भी एक्स्ट्रॉर्डिनेर करते हैं, एनिमेशन भी करते हैं, तो बंदे देखता है तो उसकी पड़ जाती है कि ये काम पाकिस्तान में कैसे हो रहा है। स्कोर भी करते हैं, फिर डायरेक्ट भी करते हैं, तो मेरा पहला सवाल है कैसे कर लेते हैं आप?
अच्छा अच्छा मैं इस वक्त डोनाल्ड ग्रोवर के साथ चाइल्डिश द न्यू चाइल्डिश गैम्बिनो के साथ
आई
कंपेयर
कांट थिंक
कर
ऑफ
रहा
एनीबडी एल्स हुज लाइक, इफ
था।
अगर मैंने एक एपिटमी पे बंदा रखना है कि यू स्टैंड अप, यू राइट 30 रॉक, यू चाइल्डिश गैम्बिनो एंड देन यू डोनाल्ड ग्लोवर, मतलब कैसे भाई, तुम क्या हो?
यार मेरे सारे जो है ना इंटीमेट रिलेशनशिप्स तबाह हुए हैं, पेडिस्टल पे रखे हुए हैं। सो आपने तो स्टार्ट ही इस तरह कर दिया कि ये तो इट्स गोना गो डाउन हिल फ्रॉम हियर
मैं तबाह
द
होना
मोमेंट आई
चाहता
वांट टू। Oh my God! I mean, this is so too much information. But the other day, my therapist was talking to me that there's this Jungian philosophy idea, dissonance about transference or projection के दरमियान के, एंड जिसके मुताबिक मुझे लगता है कि you trigger trauma in people through your excessive kindness and अब तबाह कर देते हो उनको. And I was just like, come again please, मुझे नहीं समझ आई. नहीं, मेरा कोई इरादा नहीं है आपको तबाह
मतलब
करने का.
बंदा क्या
लिसन,
करे,
आई
अब अगर अगर काइंडनेस भी आप दूसरे को तबाह कर रहे हैं, इंसान करे
तबाह कर
क्या?
रहे हैं, क्या कर रहे हैं? हाँ, या आई नो, बट ऑब्वियसली दैट्स नॉट व्हाट ही मेंट, बट इट्स अ रनिंग जोक नाउ विद माय फ्रेंड्स कि आई एम गोना
माय
डिस्ट्रॉय यू विद ऑल ऑफ माय काइंडनेस. बट आपके सवाल के जवाब में, ए आई मीन आई नो इट्स अ रिटोरिकल क्वेश्चन, बट टू बी ऑनेस्ट आई एम डिसेंट एट ऑल ऑफ दोस थिंग्स. I think I'm best at my I'm at my most self as a musician, yeah, as an academic. I'm using the word academic because I was published as a peer-reviewed in a journal, and I'm not really an academic, pseudo-academic, but that's where I feel at my most comfortable. But at the end of the day, all of these are storytelling mediums, and mera irada ye tha ke one by one, because we have a huge team and we do a lot of things, and it's a team thing. And if I am to lead, and if I have to earn respect, if I have a lawyer, or main vakil nahi hu, and if I have an anthropologist, main anthropologist nahi hu, if I have an animator, main animator nahi hu, to main seth sahab ki taraf se ye to nahi bolunga na ki this we're gonna do it this way. So I got to earn my team's respect, and one of the ways, apart from the fact that I love all of these disciplines, one of the reasons that I crafted it, I learned, tried to learn these crafts, and continue to learn these crafts, is so that I can communicate properly with the people that I'm working with. अब मैंने मुफ्ती से बात करनी है तो मुझे उनकी जबान मालूम होनी चाहिए, और मुझे इस्लामी फिक्ह की तारीख का पता होना चाहिए, अदब अल मुफ्ती पता होना चाहिए. अगर मैंने एनिमेटर से बात करनी है तो मुझे आई शुड हैव एटलीस्ट लर्नड एकेडमिकली एंड देन आल्सो प्रैक्टिस्ड अ बिट. एंड दैट्स व्हाई आई थिंक द टीम, दैट्स व्हाई द कोलैबोरेटिव प्रोसेस एंड्स अप वर्किंग, बिकॉज सो मेनी डिफरेंट डिसिप्लिन्स एग्जिस्ट इन दिस वन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. एक मुफ्ती भी है, एक एनिमेटर भी है, म्यूजिशियन भी है, ऑल दोस थिंग्स. And they're working on the same thing under the same principle. So the person who's leading them, quote unquote, should at least know a bit of everything. Apart from that, I've always wanted to tell stories. And I think all of, chahe wo academia ho, chahe wo mausiki ho, it's, you get bored of one medium. Some, don't get bored. You lose vocabulary. Aapki dictionary khatam ho jati hai. So you have a limited vocabulary with which you can express a particular trauma. Through music, and then you have to go to image, and then maybe you have to. I write terribly, by the way. So if that makes you feel any better, I write terribly.
Is that fiction writing? Because academic
Fiction.
writing तो बहुत अच्छी है।
I mean, no. What I mean right now is not the. So conceptually, even like fiction. So my first drafts are terrible, and then people keep editing it for me, and I need a lot of help. By the end, it's something. And so I wouldn't say I'm, so I can come up with good fictional stories, but I'd be terrible at putting it on paper. So, and I write terrible poetry, but I still write it, but I'm terrible at it. So yeah,
I don't know
we're,
what
I'm trying.
standards you also judge yourself by, because I saw Sheher-e
No,
Tabassum and
no,
it's phenomenal.
Well, it's written well. It's written well. So what I mean by writing is more like kya aap uski form dekhen, style dekhen. I'm not talking about substance. So Shahr-e-Tabassum mein bhi, obviously we had a huge team. Everything's team. If I were to work alone, I would be kuch bhi nahi hona tha mujhse. Ranging from the first paper that I wrote with Zan Mulvey, there's not been a single thing that I've done alone. Everything has had either a peer or a team with me. The paper I published was with Zan Mulvey, who's now in his final year of PhD in University of Virginia. That paper was
also one of the aliens that I mentioned, like you, who's an academic, plays the bass.
Oh, yeah. Oh, what a bassist. What a musician. Yeah. Unfortunately, he doesn't get the time at all to play his bass because his supervisor doesn't let him give him any time. His last thesis is working. But what a genius. I know. Incredible. And that is the paper on blasphemy law that's getting printed in hard copy with other academics later this year after 10 years of peer review. So that was with him. The Dawn article, my ex-wife, God bless her, she's an extremely, extremely good writer. If it weren't for her, it would have, the research would have been the same. I think it would have read really terribly. So, and now the organization, I'm really fortunate that we attract really interesting people. So this is part of the reason I would refuse to come in front of a camera and give a face to something. And people would not know Shahri Pakistan ke piche kaun hai, Engage ke piche kaun hai, vagaira vagaira, because idara banana. Because it also sort of gives a false impression of, oh, sab kuch. But to be honest, there's nothing that I've done. It's ideation, yes, but there's no project of substance that I've done alone. It's always been with a team.
I think when you do these things alone, Tommy Wiseau ho jata hai. So the trick is always to surround yourself with great people and knowing aapki limitations kya hai and where the other person comes in. So since you've already mentioned your academic work, let's just jump straight into it. I read the Dawn article and I think, landmine filled topic hai blasphemy law in Pakistan. But I really think you can have a conversation on it because you're not approaching it from you're approaching it academically. And agar hum academically bhi agar wo conversation nahi kar sakte to hum kaise kar sakte hain?
Bilkul, nahi bilkul sahi baat ki. I mean both the blog, so there are three main milestone write-ups jo blasphemy law ke hue hain. Ek to is the academic paper which was written very much in academic language, which is not available right now, but December ko it will be available. Bloomsbury is printing like 8 essays on blasphemy law from Muslim academics across the world. Some
this
brilliant.
This is not
academics.
The untold truth wala.
No. This is includes people from so Dr. Keisha Ali, who's an excellent feminist Muslim academic, who wrote the Ethics of Sexuality in Islam. Incredible academic. Dr. Khaled Masood, who used to be counselor of Islamic ideology. Kind of edited it. It's going to be an incredible volume. Wo mukhtalif tarz mein thi, sabse zyada journalistic and less academic version, the untold story tha. And the most, I hate to say it, think tankish, quote unquote, resource filled is the one that's available on engagepakistan.com. So all three of them have different approaches, but one thing that's common in all of these is acknowledgement ke yaar, hamari pichli generation has constantly discouraged me, except let's say, I mean, God bless her, Osman Jahangir, unhone bahut encouragement di thi. A lot of our human rights activists have, but then there are a lot of people who have seen this and said, ki aap to mazhab pe baat kar rahe hain already. That's the narrative. Why do you want to play on their pitch? And it's been a long, long process of reflection as well as studying and understanding what exactly is it that we're approaching it as within academia as well. مذہب کو ہم بطور مذہب نہیں بلکہ روایت دیکھ رہے ہیں بطور تاریخ دیکھ رہے ہیں اینڈ بطور تاریخ دان دیکھنا اینڈ بطور اینتھروپولوجسٹ کے لیوڈ ایکسپیرینس کے طور پہ دیکھنا مذہب کو آئی فیل از اسینشیل ٹو سم تھنگ لائک دی بلاسفمی لا تو مذہب سے آپ نہیں بھاگ سکتے اس کے ساتھ آپ کا تعلق جڑا ہوا ہے چاہے آپ ریاست اور مذہب کے سیپریشن پہ مانتے ہیں نہیں مانتے جو بھی آپ کا اس کے بارے میں رائے ہو آپ کا مذہبی روایت کے ساتھ آپ کا تاریخ سے تعلق ہے کیونکہ آپ کی شناخت کا تاریخ سے تعلق ہے اور آپ کی تاریخ میں مذہب ہے اور مذہبی روایت ہے. So what I mean by my approach in the Dawn articles, and I think the reason why I didn't get killed for it, even though I made very radical claims in it, was A, आई डिड नॉट ट्राई टू इंटरप्रेट एनीथिंग. मैंने ये नहीं बोला कि इस्लाम में तौहीन रिसालत की सजा कुछ नहीं है या मौत नहीं है. आई डिडंट ट्राई टू बी डॉक्टर गांधी साहब, जावेद गांधी साहब. आई डिडंट ट्राई टू बी अ थियोलॉजियन. आई डिडंट से कि इस्लाम एक पुरअमन मजहब है, या मैंने ये भी नहीं बोला कि तौहीन रिसालत इंसानी हकूक के खिलाफ है. ऑल ऑफ दीज थिंग्स फॉर मी मीन समथिंग एंड नथिंग, बिकॉज इस्लाम में तौहीन रिसालत की सजा मौत है भी और नहीं भी है. उसामा बिन लादेन का इस्लाम भी इस्लाम है, गांधी साहब का भी इस्लाम है, रवायती फिक्ह का भी इस्लाम इस्लाम है. सो व्हाट आई वांटेड टू डू वाज कि ट्रेस हमारी जो आज की रियलिटी है, जिसमें 1200 साल की तारीख बिल्कुल अंदर है हमारे, लिव्ड फियर दैट यू टॉक्ड अबाउट. इफ यू वांट टू एक्सप्लोर दैट फियर एंड इफ यू वांट टू एक्सप्लोर द वे इश्क रसूल हैज बीन वेपनाइज्ड, तो इस वेपनाइजेशन ऑफ इश्क रसूल को समझने के लिए आपको मजहब की तारीख को और इस्लामी फिक्ह की तारीख को पढ़ना पड़ेगा. अब आप पे है कि आप उसके पीछे आपकी मोटिवेशन क्या है. एटलीस्ट जब सलमान तासीर के साहब की असैसिनेशन हुई थी, आई एम अ कंप्यूटर साइंस ग्रेजुएट, मेरी डिग्री अंडरग्रेड तक है, आई नेवर गो टू अभी तक, आई हैवंट गॉन बीन एबल टू गो फॉर माय पीएचडी. दैट्स द डे व्हेन आई फेल्ट एन एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ कंप्लीट कॉन्फ्लिक्ट एंड एंजाइटी. आई फेल्ट कि मैं एक आशिक रसूल हूँ, आई लव द प्रॉफिट, बट आई कैंट रिकनसाइल दीज टू आइडेंटिटीज. वन जो कि मुझ पर मुसल्लत की जा रही है कि अगर तुम आशिक हो, यू गॉट लव दिस मैन, एंड दूसरी तरफ जो एक इंटुइटिव एज वेल एज व्हाट आई लर्न फ्रॉम हिस्ट्री के इफ आई लव द प्रॉफिट देन व्हाट. एंड इट स्टिल पेन्स मी. आई रिमेम्बर जब ये हुआ था तो गार्डियन में आर्टिकल्स आए थे, कमेंट्स में पीपल वर सेइंग द मोस्ट ऑफेंसिव थिंग्स अबाउट द प्रॉफिट, एंड आई रिमेम्बर क्राइंग बिकॉज आई फेल्ट हर्ट, बिकॉज दे आई फेल्ट हर्ट, नॉट ऑफेंडेड, आई फेल्ट हर्ट के ये मेरे प्यारे नबी के बारे में क्या कह रहे हैं. And that was the biggest motivating factor. I had a very successful software house that I had been running since I was 18, and which is the reason I was able to accumulate some capital as well. Okay, I'm going to pursue this, and that resulted in ethnography. Just my 2 years field work. Yeah, we went from seminary to seminary to try and understand that jo alfaz, jo kanoon, jo takreere hum sun rahe hain, jo claims kiye ja rahe hain from religious activists, from ulama, ya fir aam log. इसकी तारीख क्या है. एंड चाहे वो कानूनी तौर पे देखा जाए, सोशियोलॉजिकली देखा जाए, या सियासी बयानियों में देखा जाए. एंड देयरफॉर आई फील इट इज अ लेजिटिमेट, नॉट ओनली अ लेजिटिमेट, बट आई थिंक एंड्स अप बीइंग अ सेफ वे टू हैव अ कन्वर्सेशन. एंड वी कंटिन्यू टू हैव दिस कन्वर्सेशन इन अभी नाउ वी इन अदर फॉर्म्स दैट वाज रिटन फॉर्म. बट या बट इफ यू वांट वी शुड टॉक अबाउट द एक्चुअल हिस्ट्री एज वेल, बिकॉज द आर्टिकल डजंट कवर सम ऑफ द फन parts. Dawn always edits. I mean, it has to, but it had to edit some of that as well.
Go for it. Yeah, we can do a Dawn leaks here.
Let's do Dawn leaks. I mean, bless them. I remember when I wrote this article, Herald ne bheja tha, Babar sahab ki call aayi. Kehte hain, beta jaake PhD karo. Ye kya mazhab pe likhna shuru ho gaye ho? You know, all those people who are doing their, you know, PhDs. These are trend chala hua hai Near Eastern India. Jao Princeton, jao. Looks like this has nothing to do with. And then one after another, every newspaper declined to publish it. But then Dawn, not Herald, said, let's publish it. But ye ye edit karna padega. And meri us waqt kaafi ek akad thi ke ye aise hi publish hoga. Because bahut mehnat ki hai na, to main to entitled hoon to this. And it took me a long time to understand ke beta, unki zindagi aur unki as much as stake as meri. And so bless them that they published it. And after publishing it, I think people realized, Tribune wrote to me, everyone else wrote to me, could you write for me as for us as well, because it ended up being the fourth most read article on Dawn in the past 10 years on dawn.com. So if blasphemy law can be the fourth most read article, and all the other articles were about army and yeah and wo, and blasphemy was in it, and an article that criticizes the law, and I think uski wajah uski kahani ki प्रूफ भी है, बट उसकी कहानी की एब्सर्डिटी भी है. बिकॉज कहानी इट टेक्स दीस ट्विस्ट्स एंड टर्न्स. 1982 में, आई विल जंप इनटू इट, अंसार अब्बासी का एक टीनेज वर्जन जो हमारे जर्नलिस्ट हैं, गोज टू द स्टेशन विद इस्माइल, एडवोकेट इस्माइल कुरैशी साहब, जो के आर्किटेक्ट थे इस कानून के, और वकील जो जमात इस्लामी बहुत अहम वकील थे. मेरे वालिदैन जमात इस्लामी से हैं, मेरा पूरा खानदान जमात इस्लामी से है, तो कुछ फेमिलियर ताल्लुक आदमी है उनके साथ. वो गए थे, उन्होंने कहा था कि ये एक तौहीन की है, एक कम्युनिस्ट मैनिफेस्टो के साथ एक किताबचा छपा है, तो ये सुर्खें हैं, इनको ज़रा अंदर डालें, और इनकी तो कत्ल की सजा बनती है. तो देयर वॉज नो लॉ, because I mean there were many laws, but there was no law that said specifically what would happen if someone insults the Prophet. Angrez kafi chhod gaye the hamare liye mashallah se blasphemy laws. Fir baad mein, you know, 1927 mein all the Muslim communities made more laws. 80 mein phir Ziaul Haq ne ahle tashii ke khilaf 298B bhi bana diya, A bhi bana diya, badle ke taur pe, because the ahle tashii community refused to give in to the zakat ordinance ke hamara apna hai. Really strange, like badla, that's like childish badla, ke, okay, you, I'll give you this, but in return, I'll put this limitation. So there were already many blasphemy laws. And they were like, no, this requires a special law. And then 1984 mein, Ismail Qureshi saab, federal shariat court, jo us time pe federal nahi tha, shariat court mukhtalif soobo mein alahida the, petition dair karte hain, which is where you start seeing ke institution ke darmiyan separation kya hai, kya court mein ja rahe hain, keh rahe hain ke kanun saazi karne ki zarurat hai, court ko kisne appoint kiya hai to become legislator. But anyway, ke hume kanun saazi ki zarurat hai, jisme maut ki saza di jaye. Aur us petition ka kuch khas bana nahi. 86 mein, General Ziaul Haq, which jo ki ek bahut badi galti hai, hame lagta hai ki ye kanun Ziaul Haq ne pass karaya tha, and again rhetoric ka yahi masla hai ki main samet hamari human rights community sometimes says these big statements ki Ziaul Haq ka kanun. 86 mein Ziaul Haq and uska jo minister for justice tha explicitly said on the floor when the private members asked, can we need to have a law that is specifically for the Prophet which has harsh penalties. So around June 1986, mein, they were on record saying that we don't need any of those laws. We already have blasphemy laws. We have 5 of them. God damn it, we don't need another one. And shayad ye America ke pressure pe tha, because there's a lot of Christian communities ke Republican human rights type, ajeeb se white supremacist / people jo's time pe who have issues with the blasphemy law as well. Not to flame any conspiracy theories, but there are people who sympathize with the religious minorities in Pakistan who themselves are white supremacists back in America. And shayad unka dollar ka pressure tha ki jiski wajah se, for whatever the reason was, Zia and his government was against any such law. Jamaat-e-Islami, Ehrar ke jo different branches hai, Tehreek-e-Khatm-e-Nubuwwat, the Bareilvi communities, now these guys, they had been working on it. Ismail Qureshi had been working on it since 84, as I said. So jaise hi floor pe bola aapke minister of justice ne, naam main unka bhool raha hu, to unke khilaf motion kar diya ke tauheen ka to nahi kiya lekin koi bahut darane dhamkane ka, and riyasat ko samajh aa gayi aur private members se us time pe, obviously this was not a democracy, but private members elect away with it, and wo private members ne kaafi phir class li ke aap kaise keh sakte hain ke aapko mohabbat nahi nabi se, ye wahi purani tareeke, and the state gave in. Obviously, the environment that was created by Zia. Was Amir nahi wo mahol banaya jiski wajah se ye bana. Lekin iske piche jo naam hai wo agar lene hai to wo Begum Nisar Fatma sahiba hai jo Ehsan Iqbal sahab ki walida thi. Jamaat-e-Ehrar ke bade leaders hain, Liaqat Baloch ke younger self jamaat mein wo hain, Ismail Qureshi sahab hain. These people are important because some of them are alive, some of the Tarabul Haq Qadri who's not alive. So, because I got to talk to some of them. That's why these people are important, because they were the one writing, drafting. And jab unhone ye bola to unhone kaha theek hai, we're going to pass a law. Ab 9 September ko kanun saazi honi hai. Aur jab parliament mein kanun saazi hoti hai, to bill aapke saamne pesh kiya jata hai. Ab ye amendment ka bill hai ki 295A B mein C ka section add karna hai. और रूल्स के मुताबिक आपको 24 घंटे पहले तक कॉपी देनी होती है हर एक को. तो हर एक के पास कॉपी थी, और उस कॉपी में लिखा ही हुआ था, वर्ड बाय वर्ड वही लॉ था जो अभी मौजूद है, लेकिन पनिशमेंट लिखी हुई थी जिंदगी भर की कैद, मौत का कोई मेंशन नहीं था. एंड द स्पीकर को बताया जाता है कि नहीं, अब इसमें मौत भी है. एंड पीपल लाइक, अच्छा हमारे पास मौजूद नहीं है वैसे लिखा हुआ, लेकिन आप पेंसिल से लिख देते हैं. सो एवरीबडी रोट पेंसिल से के एंड और डेथ, सो ऑप्शन मौत की भी हो सकती है और उम्र कैद की भी, लेकिन वो पेंसिल से ऐड किया, विच वाज अगेंस्ट ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ प्रोसीजर्स, एंड ऑब्वियसली देयर इज अ रीजन व्हाई. सो And the thing, the absurdity of writing that with a pencil, I'm imagining it. कि अच्छा ठीक है लिख देते हैं, let's kill them. And Hamza साहब एक होते थे उस ज़माने में parliamentarian, he kept saying कि hello, what are we doing? अगर ये होना है तो let's reschedule this session. मुश्तहिर करते हैं बात को, राय लेते हैं, ये मौत अगर डालनी है तो ये किसने कहा? एंड पता ये चला कि एक स्पेशल एंड ऑब्वियसली लेजिस्लेशन में इस तरह की छोटी छोटी कमिटीज बनती है. दे सेड हमारी एक मीटिंग हुई थी जिसमें लियाकत बलोच साहब थे, तराबुल हक कादरी साहब थे, यही जो मिनिस्टर ऑफ जस्टिस गवर्नमेंट की तरफ से वो थे, और पांच छह उलमा थे. नोबडी न्यू अबाउट इट इन द पार्लियामेंट, एटलीस्ट नोबडी सेड दैट दे न्यू. हमजा साहब सेड आई वाज़न्ट टोल्ड अबाउट इट, वी डिडंट फॉर्म दिस कमिटी, एंड दैट कमिटी डिसाइडेड दैट डेथ पेनल्टी इसके अंदर इनकॉर्पोरेट की जाएगी. बट ये तो प्रोसीजरल इररेगुलैरिटी है. I'm sure हर दूसरे कानून में procedural irregularities होती हैं. The real tragedy is उस दिन पार्लियामान में, अगर आप पढ़ें, हमने ignihpakistan.com में जाएं तो किताब के किताब है, उसके एंड पे पूरी प्रोसीडिंग्स लिखी हुई हैं. It will take an hour of your time. आपका दिल भी टूटेगा और आपको गुस्सा भी आएगा. All it was either कि अगर कानून इस तरह का पास नहीं किया तो लोग आ जाएंगे बाहर तबाह करने के लिए, और अभी लोगों के अंदर ये नीड आई नहीं थी. दिस इज इन द टाइम जब पीपल वर हंग्री टू किल ब्लास्फेमर्स, वी डिडंट हैव ब्लास्फेमी हंटर्स एट दैट टाइम. दे वर क्रिएटिंग दैट नीड, दे वर क्रिएटिंग दैट एंजाइटी इन पीपल सो दैट दे कैन कंट्रोल देम लेटर. लेकिन सबसे ज्यादा अहम बात यह थी कि उन्होंने कानून पास करने के लिए कुछ माखज देने थे, और दो माखज उन्होंने दिए. एक दिया इजमा का, के जो कि इस्लामिक ज्यूरिसप्रूडेंस का एक टर्म है, विच मीन्स कंसेंसस, that is legally speaking, juridically speaking, agar kisi cheez pe tamam fuqaha throughout the centuries have been agreed on something, then it becomes a source of law according to Sunni canon. To ke ijma hai isme, and dusra unka maqas ahadees aur quran wagaira the jo ke supplementary taur pe use kiye gaye the. Quran aur hadith jo unhone istemal kiye uske bhi humne like we use that, and we so just so that there's a we don't study it as religion but we study it as study of religion, we cite all of those verses, and tarihi taur pe usko jis tarah bhi dekha gaya hai, tashreeh ki gayi hai, we put it out there, and none of that had anything to do with shatme rasool, tauheen rasool, ahanat rasool, blasphemy ko jis tarah hum baat karte hain uske jo urdu ya arabic terms hain, jo unka sahi emphasis tha wo fiqh pe tha. बार बार बात यह थी कि भाई इस पे बात हो चुकी है, 1200 साल से तमाम फुकहा ने इस पे इजमा रखा है कि जो तौहीन करेगा कत्ल किया जाएगा, और कत्ल के अलावा कुछ नहीं होगा. इसके दो इफेक्ट थे, एक ये कि अब बात नहीं होगी. बड़े ये अथॉरिटेरियन तरीका होता है कि बस बात खत्म हो गई, कंसेंसस है. सो एक रेटोरिकल डिवाइस था, और एक दूसरा एक लीगल डिवाइस था कि चूंकि इजमा है, नाउ दैट्स योर सोर्स ऑफ लॉ. उसको बैक करने के लिए दे यूज्ड 4-5 क्लासिकल टेक्स्ट. एंड द थिंग इज, अगर जहां पे भी लिखा होता था विल नॉट बी किल्ड, दे विल रिमूव द नॉट फ्रॉम इट. ला यक्तल अगर है तो ला रिमूव कर देंगे. दे कंसिस्टेंटली यूज्ड टेक्स्ट इन विच द पोजिशन रिटन वुड बी फॉर गैर मुस्लिम, कि गैर मुसलमान को कत्ल नहीं किया जाएगा. And they would say कि देखें इस किताब में इजमा है कि किसी जो भी तौहीन करेगा कत्ल किया जाएगा. दूसरी तौर पे मुसलमान के बारे में बतौर इर्तदाद यानी अपोस्टेसी इसको मेंशन किया गया था कि कलमा अगर नहीं पढ़ेगा, अगर अब आपसे पूछेंगे कलमा पढ़ोगा, कलमा नहीं पढ़ेगा तो फिर उसको कत्ल किया जाएगा. बट दे हैड अ वेरी क्लियर एंड अपोस्टेसी वाज ऑब्वियसली अबॉलिश्ड, लाइक ज़िमिट्यूड, इर्तदाद, ज़िमिट्यूड, स्लेवरी, ऑटोमन एम्पायर के क्रम्बल होने से 40-50 साल पहले दिस वॉज ऑल गॉन. So all they had was कि इस पे इजमा है, बगैर तफरीक किए कि अगर आपने फिकी इस्लामी फिकी बात में देखना है तो कि मुसलमान हो या गैर मुसलमान तो कत्ल किए जाएंगे. एंड व्हेन यू गो टू द टेक्स्ट तो होगा, द लॉजिक दैट वुड बी रिटन वुड बी कि द एक्चुअल टेक्स्ट वुड बी कि जिस जो शिर्क में, यानी अगर ज़ोरास्ट्रियन सेज दैट गॉड हैज एन ऑपोजिट, दैट इज मोर, दैट इज अ ग्रेटर सिन एंड मोर ब्लास्फेमस देन इंसल्टिंग द प्रॉफिट. But we will still give protection of life and property to those Zoroastrians because that's a social contract. I'm adding that bit. So if we do not take that protection of life and property for holding those blasphemous belief, we will not take it away if they insult the Prophet either. सो इस मंतक के बुनियाद पर लिखा होता था कि कत्ल की ममानियत थी, ये भी नहीं कि ओ कुछ और कर दें. दे वर क्लियरली सेइंग डोंट, इट्स एन इंस्ट्रक्टिव थिंग. एंड ऑल्सो के ये किस जमरे में आता है, ये शरई जमरे में आता ही नहीं था, ये आता था सियासा में. एंड सियासा वर ऑल अबाउट कॉन्क्वेस्ट ट्रीटीज, कॉन्स्टिट्यूशंस, सोशल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स. एंड दे टुक दिस फ्रॉम कॉन्क्वेस्ट ट्रीटीज के पेजेस, कि जब आपने कॉन्कर किया कहीं तो किस किस्म के लिमिटेशंस देंगे, किस किस्म के प्रोटेक्शंस देंगे टू पीपल दैट यू कॉन्कर. सो देयर इज एन एलिमेंट ऑफ सुप्रीमेसी, सुन्नी सुप्रीमेसी एंड कॉन्क्वेस्ट एंड ज़िम्मीट्यूड, ज़िम्मीज़ बीइंग यू नो वो गैर मुसलमान जो कि आपसे एक दर्जा नीचे हैं, एटलीस्ट इन दिस कॉन्टेक्स्ट. They used all of those texts, but even in those texts, it was written ki nahin qatl nahin kiya jayega. But nobody bothered to check, even though kaha tha Hamza sahab ne, jo parliamentarian ne, ke isko zara mushtahir karein, verify karwayein, lawyers se karwayein, ulama se karwayein, musliman mumalik se karwayein. I mean, 55 mumalik hain, yaar. I mean, this is not Hamza sahab, this is me. Ek mulk hai, jo laga hua hai, ki sirf qatl hoga, bataur had hoga, maafi bhi nahi hogi. Throughout time and space, this is a very modern law. There's no precedent for it. This is a very modern law. Jitna wo kehna chahte hain, this is an ancient law, this is God's law. We are an anomaly across time and space with what we have done with this law, both in terms of the law as well as the way we have started monopolizing what Ishq-e Rasool means. Anyway, that's what happened in the blasphemy law. They lied their butts off completely throughout the proceeding. Inaccurate, opposite of what was actually there in the text. And one person, God bless him, kept saying, ke yaar, please, mushtahir kar de. And usko bolte rahe, itni dhamkiyan di logon ne. And end pe voting hui. Oh, us voting mein bhi ijma nahi tha. Our minority representatives all said yay to it. The Christian community was completely, the Christian community leadership was very much behind the blasphemy law. Because unko promise ye kiya gaya tha ki ye Ahmadiyon ke khilaf hai. And there's always been historically a tension between the Ahmadi community and the Christian community because of the theological beliefs on Jesus. And unko ye bataya gaya tha ki ye aapke liye nahi hai. Ye the Minister for Religious State Affairs walon ki ek taqreer 89 mein hai ki aapko ghabrane ki zarurat nahi hai, aapke liye thori hai. Ab mujhe bhi maloom hai, aapko bhi maloom hai ye kin ke liye hai. I mean, ab ye har ek ke liye obviously. Ab to ye GHQ walon ke liye bhi hai. But us time pe unke kuch aur khayalat the. So this happened, got passed, but at that time, it was still not Hud. Hud means divinely ordained, Khuda ka kanun, written as is, can't change it. So you still have some room for conversation. And that was not okay for the religious activists and the religious political leadership. So Jamaat-e-Islami ke advocate Ismail Qureshi ne petition dair ki 1991 mein. So 86 mein legislation ho gayi. 91 mein Federal Shariat Court mein us legislation ki tashreeh karayi gayi ke ye qatl hi hoga. Umar qaid ho hi nahi sakti. Qatl ke alawa koi saza ke bare mein koi baat karega to wo khuda ke diye hue commandment ke khilaf baat karega. Isko had, bataur had isko tashreeh ki jaye. Halanki hudood ordinance mein hai bhi nahi. Strange enough, ye hamare taziraati jo kitab hai na uske andar. So tazir aur had are opposite. Tazir are discretionary punishment that human beings come up with, and had are divine punishments. So abhi tak ye Pakistan penal code mein hudood ordinance mein hai nahi, but federal shariat court ke samne bhi yahi hua. The petition that Ismail Qureshi wrote, jo ki humne 5000 rishwat deke badi mushkilon se nikalwayi aur usme bhi redacted the Islamabad se, uff, jo uske andar inaccuracies maujood hain, jis like ek undergrad bachelor's ka first year ka banda jab essay likhta hai aur kehta hai maine 55 citations padhi hain, aur aapko pata hota hai yaar nahi padhi aapne jitni jo citations unhone likhi hui hain, and every citation that you go jhoot bole ya incompetence bole, mujhe to pata hai jhoot hai because he knew what he was doing. So again, that's that petition. I would have everyone read that petition. We've scanned that underneath it, and then is petition ke taur pe jo judgment hui thi, that is be Allah hafiz us judgment ka, that was terrible because it would say something like, misal de deta hu so that people understand the gravity of the lies that we have been experiencing and that we live every day. Ke judgment mein likha hua hai, Jassas says, Jassas was a Hanafi jurist, ke kill all blasphemers, etc. And when you go to Jassas, Jassas is saying a غیر مسلمان ہوگا تو قتل نہیں کیا جائے گا, مسلمان ہوگا تو کلمہ پڑھنے کے لیے کہا جائے گا, کلمہ نہیں پڑھے گا تو بطور ارتداد اسے سزا دے دی جائے گی. So I'm not going to sugarcoat it. Apostasy کا کہتے تھے مسلمانوں کے لیے, but lived experience میں apostasy laws کو بھی کس طرح دیکھا گیا throughout history, وہ بھی اگر دیکھا جائے, they always tried not to get, you know, implemented. And then again, slavery کی بھی ہسٹری رہی ہے, وہ abolish ہو گیا تھا. ارتداد کی بھی ہسٹری رہی ہے, abolish ہو گیا تھا. But that's not what they were claiming. They were claiming یہ حد ہے, اہانت رسول, توہین رسول بطور subject has been of great interest to Islamic jurisprudence, when it hasn't. You have to really comb through volumes upon volumes, or do jumle milenge, someone even cares about it. Ke acha theek hai, what happens when they do that? They probably care more about ke aapki sawari ki hai. Ek gair musliman ghode pe chadte hue aa raha hai aapke samne se, to usko rukna padega. They probably spent more time on that than they spent on this. I'm not exaggerating here. So Federal Shariat Court, again, udhar saath jurisconsults bhi gaye the, Hanafi zyadatar the. Hanafi being the school of thought جہاں سے یہ سب کچھ بطور سورس لیا جا رہا تھا, انہوں نے بھی بولا تھا کہ ہاں اس میں اختلاف موجود ہے, حد شاید یہ نہیں ہے. دے premises of that judgment are so strange, and then the conclusion all of a sudden says ہاں یہ حد ہے اور حد کے علاوہ کوئی سزا نہیں ہوگی اور خدا کا قانون ہے. دو تین اچھی چیزیں اس میں دے دی گئی تھیں جو کہ ہم نہیں اس کو فوکس کرتے. ایک یہ کہ اس میں بتا دیا گیا تھا کہ نیت لازمی ہے. سو one of the lazy things we've done over the past 20-30 years, the progressive community has not read enough material before making certain claims. Yes, it is true that mens rea, yani ke niyat, malicious intent, is not in the letter of the law, but juridically speaking uski jo tashreeh hai usko istemal kiya ja raha hai. Ab lower courts mein wakeel bhi istemal kar rahe hain, niyat hona zaruri hai. Aur bade aaram se aap parliament mein ye بات لا سکتے ہیں کہ فیڈرل شریعت کورٹ نے خود کہہ دیا تھا کہ نیت ہونا ضروری ہے, تو آپ اس کو ڈونٹ آرگیو آن ہیومن رائٹس گراؤنڈ, آرگیو آن دیئر اون. سو دیٹ واز ون تھنگ, بٹ دین دا کورٹ سیٹ کہ یہ تو قتل ہوگا اور کچھ نہیں ہوگا, یہ حد ہے. سو یو ہیڈ دا ایکویژن حد پلس اجماع از ایکول ٹو گاڈز لا بائی دیٹ ٹائم, اینڈ دیٹ کیلکولس از دا ریزن دا اسٹارٹ آف آر ڈوم, کہ نہ صرف یہ خدا کا دیا ہوا قانون ہے, بٹ یہ ایک ایسا خدا کا دیا ہوا قانون ہے جس پہ تاریخی طور پر کسی فقہا میں سے کسی نے اختلاف کیا ہی نہیں. اس میں تو کسی اور کی کوئی رائے رہی نہیں, تو اب کس کی رہ سکتی ہے؟ ان فیکٹ اب کوئی اور کوئی رائے دے گا تو نہ صرف وہ انارملی ہوگا, بٹ وہ خود بھی ایک شاید شاتم ہو سکتا ہے. اس طرح کی بات چیت بھی آتی ہے, وچ از ویئر سلمان تاثم لائک سلمان تاثیر کمز ان. سو دیٹ ٹیکٹک, which is very much a tactic, because I got to meet a lot of these people, and they explicitly say, Fareed Pracha explicitly says, کہ ہاں مولانا مودودی نے بولا تھا کہ توہین رسالت کی سزا موت نہیں ہے, تو ضروری تو نہیں ہے کہ ان کی بات مانی جائے. But when he comes on television, he says, اس پہ تو اجماع ہے, ہم کیسے اختلاف کر سکتے ہیں, اس پہ تو ہر ایک نے یہی بولا ہے. اسماعیل قریشی himself said کہ ہاں ہے اختلاف ہے, لیکن اس وقت جو ہے نا سیکولرز جو ہیں وہ ریاست کا جو ہے نا ہماری شناخت چھیننا چاہتے ہیں. So bunch of hypocrites a lot, but the point is we've reached 91 تشریح ہو گئی. Then comes the really interesting part. Nawaz Sharif ki hukumat hai, and the government has the right to challenge this, right? Because the case is happening between Ismail Qureshi versus the state. Ismail Qureshi is challenging ke 86 mein state ne jo law pass kiya wo Quran aur hadith ke khilaf hai, because umar qaid ki option kyun maujood hai. Judgment aayi, it was very easy. Any lawyer worth his degree or whatever could come in and he could have challenged this. جب وہ چیلنج کیا فوراً اسماعیل قریشی, اینڈ دس از ون آئی میٹ اسماعیل قریشی, ہی ٹولڈ می کہ آئی وینٹ ٹو نواز شریف فادر, اینڈ دین بیکاز ہی تھاٹ کہ او مظہر صاحب کا بیٹا ہے, جماعت اسلامی سے ہے, تو یہ تو ختم نبوت کا نیکسٹ لیڈر بننا ہے, اس کیریزمیٹک لڑکا ہے, ٹیلنٹڈ ہے, اس کو میں سارے انر سیکرٹس بتاتا ہوں. آئی مین آئی ڈنٹ لائی, آئی ڈنٹ گو دیئر پریٹینڈنگ ٹو بی سم ون آئی ایم ناٹ, بٹ ہی جسٹ کیم اینڈ ہگڈ می فار ٹو منٹس, تھاٹ دیٹ آئی واز دی نیکسٹ قادری اور سم تھنگ. And he sat me down and he told me all these things. And he said, I went to Muhammad, Nawaz Sharif's father, and I told him, aapke ghar milad hote hain, aap to aashiq-e-rasool hain, aapke bete ke government mein ye petition gayi hai. And then he acted as, it was funny in a weird sort of way, ke mere samne usne telephone milaya aur bola, Nawaz, ye foran wapas loge tum. Ab aap, you know, it's strange. Nawaz Sharif's daddy issues came in, whatever came in, but ایک باپ کے کہنے پہ he took that challenge back. And uske baad 6 mahine ka time hota hai, I don't know, 12 mahine ka vakil jante hain, lekin guzar gaya time. There's only a certain period of time until you can challenge a judgment.
Hmm.
And that would have been the best way to settle things. And that was taken away from us by Nawaz Sharif and his father and his daddy issues and Ismail Qureshi, obviously. In all of these things, Ismail Qureshi's hands are there. Khatme Nubuwwat folks' hands are there. Jamaat ke logo's hands are there. And the third, I think, milestone. So, ek political ho gaya, ek juridical ho gaya, ek social jo ek, kyunki kanoon to kanoon hai, lekin aksar qatl to baghair kanoon ke ho rahe hain. That is the role of religious activists. I won't always say scholars because it's interestingly enough, people who have written the most against the blasphemy law have been traditional scholars in Pakistan. It's just that we've never known about them. Mujhe aise aise risale maine 96 ke 2001 ke 2004 ke jahan pe log kab se bol rahe hain ki ye kanoon to sahi hai hi nahi, maut ki saza kya matlab, ye bahut pehle se bol rahe hain. But those are journal unke apne ivory tower ke journals jo ek subculture mein phir rahe hain, and you know we never find out about them. But the religious activists, the new phenomena in South Asia, and again a modern phenomena, you never had Tehreek-e-Khatm-e-Nubuwwat. Can you imagine 16th sadi mein Tehreek-e-Khatm-e-Nubuwwat ho rahi hai? Very influenced by early 20th century politics of organizing and politics and activism, and the way of organizing was also very influenced by Marx and the left ki movements. So Ehrar that came in 1935, is tarah ki jo jamaatein thi, उन लोगों का जो किरदार है, अब उसमें बाज़ लोग मुफ्तियान भी हैं, but they're activists. So someone like Mufti Naeem, I consider him, I mean the late Mufti Naeem, के वो मुफ्ती भी है, but he's also an activist because he's going to come on television and he's going to push an agenda like an activist. So he's their version of Jibran Nasir. So Khadim Rizvi, all of those people, they're activists. They consistently did the most nefarious things. Now, I've given examples in the book that go beyond what I gave in the article. This includes one of the people who called for Mumtaz Qadri's. I'm coming to an end with this long story. Give me five.
It's a very important story. Mumtaz, it's an untold story.
Yeah, it's important. I believe it's important, which is why I'm taking my time. Mumtaz Qadri ki, after Salman Taseer's statement came in, bahut kuch hua. Already, Mufti Naeem's Madrasa Jame Banoria ki website pe ek fatwa maujood tha ke tauheen e saad ki saza kiya hai. And this is before Salman Taseer's assassination that I started collecting and documenting things. And I found a fatwa jo unhone diya hua tha, jawab likha hua tha ke dekhiye saza kuch bhi ho sakti hai. Chahe musliman ho, gair musliman ho, maaf bhi kar sakte hain, kuch bhi kar sakte hain. Aur niche unhone Radal Mukhtar Ibn Abidin ka wo diya hua tha, who's a jurist, chief justice the wo Ottoman Empire ke, one of the biggest Hanafi jurists of all time, the go-to person in South Asia, Ibn Abidin. And jaise hi Salman Taseer ne wo statement di, around that time, before assassination or during assassination, because Mufti Naeem went on television and said ki sirf ek saza hai maut hai, they removed that. And they replaced it with a different fatwa which said qatl, qatl or sirf qatl type, right? Not in these words, but it was that. It was the opposite. But I had already downloaded it, and if you read them, it would feel like ye to do mukhalifin baat kar rahe hain. But it was the same institution. So clearly they knew what they were doing. They went in there to their database, they deleted it, they uploaded a new one. But you had some even more insidious things happening. Ashraful Qadri and Hanif Qureshi, do muftis hain, who fanned the flames at that time. Ki Mumtaz Qadri, someone needs to be a Mumtaz Qadri. Someone needs to be our next Ghazi al-Muddin. Ghazi al-Muddin is one of the many, right? So they have this tradition of 11-12 Ghazi jin ka naam lete hain. To 13wa kaun banega, 14wa kaun banega? And Hanif Qureshi ki YouTube pe video maujood hai, that's very popular, jisme he's going in batshit crazy ke churiya pehni hai tumne. Iske na gender bhi bada interesting hai, the masculinity of it. Ke kaise chup karoge tum usse? Tum usko baaton se chup karaoge? And they would say, nahi. Kis tarah karaoge? Goliyon se chup karaoge, and they would say, goliyon, challi, challi kar doge. It's crazy. But that's rhetoric, right? Then you have Ashraful Qadri. Iske khilaaf parcha bhi khata tha Hanif Qureshi ke. Ye to UK ka chakkar lagate rehta hai. Hame visa nahi milte, ye chakkar lagate rehta hai. I mean, I keep emailing these things to these folks. Ke, yaar, ye banda hai jis jo baith ke udhar. Khatm-e-Nubuwwat has a huge network in Europe. Even
printing presses in the UK.
Yeah. even like a lot of books that are published in Urdu that are somehow distributed here, there are some of them are in Germany. I got one shut down by talking to an academic over there who talked with the intelligence over there. For whatever reason, they were printing Urdu hate material in Germany. But anyway, that aside, that was a tangent. Muftri Ashraful Qadri, he has this video, which he deleted, but I also have this video, in which he has this text in front of him. So imagine I have this text in front of him. It's a text, it's a seminal text. It's by a jurist called Ibn Taymiyyah, very popular. Not really belonging to Hanbali school of thought, which is the fourth fiqh school, but somewhat of a pre-Salafi, but a very excellent logician. I hate his positions, very extreme, very violent, but a very good logician.
I think quite a large portion of the Tablighi Jamaat is inspired by him. Or
No, not Tablighi Jamaat. Tablighi Jamaat is not inspired by him, but a lot of the Saudi Wahhabi jurisprudence is inspired by him, because he is a very anti-Hanafi guy. And Tablighi Jamaat wale people are Hanafi. So this is Ibn Taymiyyah, jisko misquote karke Al-Qaeda ne bhi fatwa likhwaye the, ke, because he had a lot of positions on jihad. Because this, he was around the time of great conflict with the Mongols, wagaira. So he came at a great time of conflict. He was a really well-read person. Main pata nahi kyun tareefe kyun kar raha hun uski. Anyway, he had terrible positions. So he had this book, jisme he wanted to prove that everyone who has written about blasphemy before me has been wrong. That the traditional position on blasphemy is wrong, especially the Hanafis are wrong. Actually, main tauheen ke saath hi zyada maut hai. And this Hanafi dude takes this book and says, "Vaise to ye iman ki maut nahi mara tha," because they hate Ibn Taymiyyah, because he criticizes Abu Hanifa, which is one of their saints for them. So he says, "Vaise to ye banda, ye kitab jiski main pad raha hu, ye Hanafi nahi hai, hum Hanafi hain, aur ye iman ki maut nahi mara tha, kyunki his theological views were God sits on a throne, all of those things. Lekin this book compiles all four school of thoughts ki position, to main isme se aapko padh ke batata hu." And then usme wo kholta hai, and he wants to read the position of Abu Hanifa, because everyone in front of him are people who follow Abu Hanifa. Hanafi school of thought is the one that's followed in Pakistan by majority of the people. Bareilvi, Deoband, dono Hanafi hain. And then he starts reading. And he starts reading. And likha hua hai ke falana, a jurist said that kill whoever insults the Prophet. Baat Muslim ke chapter mein ho rahi hai, but as I said, we don't differentiate in our narrative ki Musliman aur ghair Musliman mein ki tafreeq hai ki nahi. And for Abu Hanifa ka time pe aata hai na, to he changes the Arabic. The Arabic in there was that you will not kill the non-Muslim, because already what he's doing, what he believes in and what he expresses is much more heretical. So wohi wali analogy. He, instead of saying that, so I have the text in front of me, the same text that he's saying, he says, misluhu, yani isse milti julti misal hi aapko Abu Hanifa mein milegi, people of Kufa jahan. So, and he doesn't say it in Urdu. He's, I don't remember the exact words. Arabi mein bolta hai ki haan, Abu Hanifa ke bhi yahi position hai. And he's the man with the book on the heightened chair. And then you see the faces of the people, including a young man, and who seems, I don't know, distressed. I don't know if I'm projecting. Ki acha, ab to, I have to go and kill some blasphemers now. Because clearly this man knows his shit. He's saying it out of a book. The book looks heavy. He's saying it in Arabic. I don't know Arabic. And his beard is long. He's a mufti. So clearly, jhoot to nahi bol sakta. Kitab parke, nobody in their vibe, I couldn't have imagined. And by that time, I had seen a lot of misrepresentation. But to see the kind of misrepresentation where aap saamne dekhte hue achanak arbi tabdeel kar dein, shows the kind of nefarious and serious things that were happening. And then someone one-upped him. And obviously, we know then what happened. Mumtaz Qadri, I'm not saying Mumtaz Qadri listened to him and killed him, but the narrative that created Mumtaz Qadri. Humne to Qadri ko maar diya, because we think that killing people is the solution. We killed him and we turned him into a symbol again, which I don't think we should have killed him. But Ghazi usse bana diya humne. I don't know. But Mumtaz Qadri, jo symptom hai jis cheez ka, wo abhi tak zinda phir rahe hain. Jin logon ne janboojh kar jhoot bola, logon ko bewakoof banaya, aur banate aa rahe hain. Nobody's taking them to the courts, to the cleaners. Hanif Qureshi, after saying all the things that he said, ke churiyan pehni hai, goli maar do, apne usne लिखा हुआ है ऑन 20 रुपए का पेपर कि हम तो सूफी हैं भाई, बरेलवी है वो, हम तो अमन पसंद लोग हैं, हम इस तरह की बातें नहीं करते. एंड ही वॉज लेट गो ऑफ. सो दैट्स वन लेसन टू बी लर्न. बट दिस मिसरिप्रेजेंटेशन की सबसे एक्सट्रीम फॉर्म मैंने देखी जामिया इस्लामिया कराची में, एक मदरसा है वेरी पॉपुलर अगेन. दे टुक दैट सेम टेक्स्ट एंड समवन आस्क्ड, बिकॉज दिस क्वेश्चन इज आस्क्ड अ लॉट दाउल इफ्ता में, जो जहाँ पे फतवेज बनते हैं, कि अगर कोई बंदा तौहीन करे तो उसकी क्या सजा होती है. एंड उन्होंने पूरा जवाब दिया हुआ है कि हनफी, बतौर हनफी, इट्स अ बुक कलेक्शन ऑफ हनफी फतवाज दैट दे हैव गिवन. दे गिव एवरी पोजिशन ऑफ एवरी स्कूल ऑफ थॉट एंड देन दे से डॉट 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 एंड देन दे मूव फॉरवर्ड. And that dot, dot, dot really bothered me for two reasons. A, because there were like 8 or 9 random dots. And that's not how ellipses work. There are 3 dots. But the second reason was, yeah, why, what are you hiding? Was it a long text? And I don't see any Hanafi position in there. So when we go into the actual text, strangely enough, it was the same text. And usme bhi yehi likha hua tha ke wahi wali baat, qatl nahi kiya jayega. And they're hiding it. The various means and instruments and tactics through which they have obfuscated the truth, through which they have revised history, through their, which manufactured a narrative, is worse than what Orwell could have written. We're in like a post-Orwell dystopia. The kinds of horrible, horrendous ways in which these people of authorities have lied time and again by fabricating things. The important part here is, I'm not talking about Islam mein tauheen-e-risalat ki saza kya hai. I'm talking about jis natije mein hum aaj pahunche hain batar muashra aur jo jamhoor raaye hai, wo jamhoor raaye pe pahunchne ke liye jin logon ne baat ki hai 3 authorities mein, judicial, political and our religious activists/authorities. Wo jin maakhiz pe buniyad pe apne claims karte rahe hain, unhone complete jhoot bola hai. And people bought it as they have done throughout history in any organized religion. And it is time for us to look into those, not just sources, but talk to those people. I have no intention of, I'm making a documentary, we'll talk about it. I'm no intention of saying, gotcha, jhoot bol rahe the na tum. I can imagine right now, agar Liaquat Baloch sahab ka zameer jaag bhi jaye, he's a politician. I need to give him a narrative that is palatable. That's my job. काउंसिल ऑफ इस्लामिक आइडियोलॉजी ने हमारी रिसर्च ली और किबला याज साहब, ग्रेट मैन, द चेयरमैन, ही रोट, वी इंडोर्स दिस रिसर्च. मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ह्यूमन राइट्स में शीरी मजाई सेज एक्सलेंट रिसर्च, बट हाउ विल वी ब्रिंग इट टू पार्लियामेंट. मैं नजर देख रहा हूँ, मैं क्या, आई मीन यू विल ब्रिंग इट टू द पार्लियामेंट. बट आई डू थिंक कि वी नीड टू गिव देम समथिंग जिससे उनका वोट बैंक भी महफूज रहे, बिकॉज अदरवाइज दे वोंट डू एनीथिंग. एंड दीज इंस्टीट्यूशंस कैन टॉक टू ईच अदर. Because I remember being like a, meri gari CII ki building se leke Ministry of Human Rights ki building aage piche chal rahi thi, because I was somehow the mediator between the two institutions. It didn't work out, nothing worked out, but it showed me, it was really frustrating, but it showed me a lot of work needs to be done, where we bring together a lot of people and engage, which is the name of our organization as well. We engage them in a language that finally has common ground. I don't want to give up my principles. I believe that I believe that these are not the way you, so I don't want to say ke Pakistan mein Hanafi law lao. That's not what I believe in, absolutely not. You need to minimize your theological resources through which you craft your state, absolutely. You need to separate, you need, aapka tyranny of majority nahi ho sakti, aapki Sunni supremacy nahi ho sakti. However, tarihi taur pe dekha jaye, because we are, as I said, living those histories, all these people, and to dumb it down so that some of these idiots can understand it in power, and because unki bhi aajkal phati hui hai, because at the end of the day jab Faizabad ka hua tha to someone ended up saying na ki GHQ wale log bhi to kar rahe hain, so everyone's scared, because now it's weaponized to an extent ki it's gone out of hand. So there is a stake that these people in politics jo ke bahut realists hain, they want to tone things down. And I think all of us need to amplify each other, distribute risk amongst each other. If I direct a documentary, someone else needs to take ownership of it, turn it into like a mini story and write an article on it, so that the risk is so distributed, so that the monopoly that this group has on Ishq-e Rasool, on Ghazi kaun hai ji, Ghaddar kaun hai, Ghairatmand kaun hai, Gustakh kaun hai, sare G's unhone liye hain. लाइक सब कुछ उन्होंने बताना है, हमारे पास तो कुछ हक ही नहीं है, लाइक गालियां भी वही देंगे. एंड दिस इज अगेन लिंग्विस्टिक, देयर इज दिस आइडिया दैट आई एम एक्सप्लोरिंग दीस डेज एंड दैट्स प्रोबब्ली गोइंग टू माय पीएचडी एज वेल, द वेपनाइजेशन ऑफ इश्क रसूल, कि लैंग्वेज में, व्हिच वाज आल्सो व्हाट शेर तबस्सुम एंड स्वाइप इज अबाउट, व्हेन यू टेक अ वर्ड and you force it to hold only one meaning, it inherently becomes violent. And when you take a word and you allow it to hold infinite meanings,
yep,
it will collapse on itself as well. And that, it's, there's a theory, there's work being done on it, semantic range analysis ka, which proves that as well. So if you take ishq, and Turki mein you say ishq rasool, no one's gonna go like, oh, what are we talking about here? No one's gonna say, honor equals killing, ishq equals violence. In Pakistan, this association and instruction is very new. The only alternative I can think is Coke Studio is defining ishq rasool sometimes for us. So how sad is that? A corporation and like, you know, these people. Darakht lagana cannot be ishq rasool in practice. So they've forced it to hold only one meaning. So it has become an instrument of control. On the other hand, gustakh ka, they've allowed it to hold infinite meaning, which means chaos. So that idea of throughout time and space, you've narrowed down what it means to be an ashik, and you've broadened as much as you want what it means to be a gustakh and ghaddar as well. But that's a separate story. And you've broadened it. And now you've got Twitter. So anybody can say anything. That's gustakhi, that's gustakhi. And that's why you have got absurd cases, ridiculous cases. And so we need to come in, not just from a point of legal, juridical, but also people who want to express their love for the Prophet in different ways, do it. It doesn't make you any less secular if you love the Prophet, if you want to say that I love the Prophet. It's a very personal issue, yes, but write a song about it, sure. Which is why I love the soundtrack to Zindagi Tamasha as well. It was very spiritual.
What a great elucidation of where we are and how we got here. Aapne ye bhi mentioned kiya ki Christian community, they got on board by saying ki Ahmadiyon ke khilaaf hai. One of the most famous courts in the world is that German court. First they came for the socialists, and I said nothing because I wasn't a socialist. Wo Pakistan mein bhi apply ho sakta hai ki agar hum apni tareekh dekhen, bhai, first they came for the Sikhs, and I said nothing because I was not a Sikh. Then they came for the Hindus, and I said nothing.
Yes,
I was not Hindu. Then they came for the Ahmadis, and I said nothing because I was not Ahmadi. And now it seems like they're coming for the Shias. And agar hum at least kanoon saazi mein dekhen, the Shias supported the Ahmadi persecution.
Yeah. I want to clarify Christian community ki leadership. Because there is an elite leadership which is very rich as well. And the moment they have an NGO, somehow paise bhi aa jate hain unke paas bahut zyada. And there is some corruption in there as well. But Christian community in general, if they're silent, it's because they're scared. But the leadership is definitely was always behind it. If not always, then most of the times. And Ahle Tashia again, 1927 mein jab kanun pass hua, Qaide Azam bhi the, bhai sare hi the, sabne keh diya ke ji saza, the only way to resolve honor of the Prophet and protect it, as if it requires protection anyway, and as if hamari auqat hai to protect the honor of someone like that. Anyway, wo hum sabne pass kiya. 80 mein jab Ahle Tashia khilaf kanun saazi hui,
just on the Qaide Azam point, I think a lot of seculars and liberals also try to own Qaide Azam. But in the Ghazi Ilmuddin case, it's quite clear Qaide Azam was supporting him. Usme, to history is very clear what Qaide's position was.
Yeah. I mean, so I don't want to make a claim here because slightly outside my circle. But I know one thing. Okay, I don't care what Qaide Azam said that much. I mean, I care, but not the way the USA people kind of like worship their founding fathers. I care about my people, man. And I care about our history, not because I want to replicate it. I want to know the truth. I want to know the truth of Qaide Azam because he's part of me. And if what I've given is a false history, then my own identity is false. Main apni shanakht nahi kar paunga. So I do believe Qaide Azam gets romanticized a lot.
By both sides, both extremes.
By both sides, yeah. I also believe that sometimes Iqbal's philosophy isn't. So if you talk to someone who really knows his stuff, a very flawed man, I'm not the biggest fan, but in philosophy, he had done some incredible work. And now you would have a physicist, human rights person who I would respect come in and say, what did he know? When he wouldn't know the depth of philosophy that he did. Now, I'm not a philosopher, but I know enough philosophers of religion, Jewish philosophers of religion, teachers, professors in academia who really appreciate what he did. But then again, with flaws, we don't need to think in binaries, as you said. But to the Ahlet Tashi point, in 1980s, se pehle pehle tak, there was no blasphemy laws that was just for the Shia community. Throughout history, it was understood that sometimes they say things that do not go along with our beliefs, and it's probably going to offend you. If you're a Sunni, it's probably going to offend you in some way. Okay, so a psychology of offense ko bhi thoda dekhna chahiye, honor ko bhi thoda dekhna chahiye. Aapki begum dupatta pehen ke bahar aa gayi to aapka dil mein jalan kyun hoti hai? Aapke aur hoti hai. It's an actual physical sensation that men have. What is this masculine way of experiencing honor where it isn't inside you, it is outside of you, it's in women and prophets. That's where the honors reside. Ye aapki representation hai. So you kill for honor, you kill for honor. And that really fascinates me as well as disturbs me, that there is a element of masculinity and insecurity about yourself jo aap project karte ho phir un anxieties ko outside. But Ahle Tashi community ke maamle mein, because Islamabad mein unhone Islamabad band kar diya tha 1980s mein, they went to Islamabad, they said ki aapka jo ye act hai zakat and it was called something else, ordinance, ye hum pe lagu nahi ho sakta. Hamari fiqh hamesha se alada thi, 1200 saal se ya 1000 saal, whatever you want to count it as, hamesha se alada thi, ab bhi alada rahegi.
Thanks to them, Pakistani banking accounts mein 97% Shia hai.
Oh man, I hate banks, so I never end up going.
Mujhe bank ne phone kiya ki sir Ramzan aa raha hai, aap ek letter likh dein ki aap Shia hai.
Oh my god.
इतने पैसे ही नहीं है मेरे खेत में, कोई ज्यादा बड़ा अमाउंट हो.
या इंसान ये क्या के छोड़ देता है ना, लाइक पूरा बैंक जाए. इट्स लाइक आई हेट बैंक्स मैन. आई थिंक आई हेट द इंटीरियर आर्किटेक्चर ऑफ बैंक्स, एंड आई हेट देयर लैंग्वेज, द एब्रिविएशंस दैट दे यूज. एंड देन यू फाउंड आउट, अच्छा ये मतलब था इसका. वकील और बैंकर्स दोनों, इन्वेस्टमेंट बैंकर्स एंड वकील, दे यूज दे हाइड बिहाइंड दीस फैंसी टर्म्स व्हिच डोंट रियली मीन अ लॉट. बट एनीवे 80s में फिर उन्होंने वो किया, राइट. एंड अब दूसरी तरफ से कुछ सुन्नी एक्टिविस्ट एंड आई वुड कॉल देम सुप्रीमेसिस्ट फोर्सेस थे, जिनको अपीज करने के लिए ज़ियान उन पे अगले दिन, लाइक एक दिन में ऑर्डिनेंस साइन कर दिया. एंड दैट्स अ वन मैन साइनिंग, दैट्स अ रियल ज़िया लॉ, राइट. ऑर्डिनेंस 295C कानून तौहीन रिसालत वाज नॉट एन ऑर्डिनेंस, इट वाज पास्ड थ्रू अ कोट एंड कोट समवट डेमोक्रेटिक प्रोसेस. बट ये तो उन्होंने रिवेंज लॉ था. Now, one would imagine that aapke saath jitna zulm aur jabr hua 80 ki dahai mein, jhang se jo log nikle, lashkar-e-jangvi wale, sipa sahaba wale, jitna aapke saath zulm hua, jitni aapke saath persecution hui aur hoti aa rahi hai, that when the time came, by 86, Shia, Ahl-e-Tashi community had faced a lot. So you would say something, at the very least you wouldn't be silent, but they didn't. They didn't. They, I don't know how, I have more documentations, let's say, of the Christian communities being comfortable with it. But abhi bhi, Iran se leke, because Salman Rushdie ki kitab aayi thi 89 mein. The people at the forefront were your Ayatollah Iran mein. Ke fatwa to udhar se aaya tha. So you're right. Wohi wali baat hai ke ultimately, aapki bari, and it's a cycle. थोड़ा सा टाइम आया था दरमियान में वेयर अहले तशी कम्युनिटी वाज नॉट बीइंग टारगेटेड, नाउ दे आर बीइंग टारगेटेड इन अ डिफरेंट वे, एंड द लॉ दैट दे आर यूजिंग द वेपनाइजिंग 298A वो इतना इस तरह इस्तेमाल नहीं हो रहा था जो अब फिर से शुरू हो गया. एंड इट फील्स समथिंग फील्स रॉन्ग इन द वे इट्स हैपनिंग, इट फील्स वेरी सिस्टमैटिक.
298A तो इज नॉट रिलीजन स्पेसिफिक एज वेल, राइट? इट अप्लाइज टू ऑल.
इट इज नो, इट्स नॉट रिलीजन स्पेसिफिक, बट जिस ऑफेंस की वो बात करते हैं, the only community that's going to probably do it is the Shia community, because it talks about the wives of the prophet and the companions of the prophet.
So naya daur ka bhi jis tarah article bhi aaya tha ki pichle mahine 42 cases blasphemy ke registered hue hain, and a lot of times people claim ke ji social media ab zyada hai to khabrein zyada aa rahi hain, but hamesha se yahi ho raha tha. But as somebody who's researcher as much as anybody. Hai to anomaly, right? This the fact that ye spike jo aa raha hai, ye more of the same nahi hai. And specifically, no, Shias agar being target ho rahe hain, and for reciting things that they have recited for centuries.
Ever. Yeah, I mean, agar Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan was alive today, तो इमरान खान बैठ के ये नहीं कह रहा होता एक बार फिर से जरा वो सुनाओ तो सही.
हाँ, और गोरख धंधा ही आई थिंक वो किया था.
yeah?
रिक्वेस्ट.
yeah, yeah, वो अमिताभ बच्चन के साथ बैठा हुआ था, कह रहा था फिर से जरा करते हो, अब करके दिखाया कोई. सो वी डोंट इवन हैव टू गो बैक सेंचुरीज इफ समवन्स अ हिस्टोरियन टू सी के हाउ बैटशिट क्रेजी थिंग्स हैव गॉन.
आई मीन साबरी ग्राफ, आई डोंट नो इफ यू रिमेंबर, बट खैर वो एक्सटॉर्शन में उनका डाल दिया, बट एआरवाई और जियो का जब फड्डा हो रहा था,
bigger thing, like including 295A, 295C, 298A, 298BC. Overall, the thing is technology, which is why I'm very interested in our second film as well, which looks into technology and accusations and false accusation. What technology does is the same thing what printing press did. So a time tha, jab, if you would say something offensive, let's say in the 9th century, to awaaz aage baat zyada nahi jaani. Number two, printing press nahi tha, log to Quran bhi nahi padte the. People didn't have Qurans in their houses. The way they practiced religion was very different. And number three, the way they followed was ke, haan, they would take it to a mufti if there was a case. And the muftis usually were always, at least what we read in academic books, ke, they were very cautious of just like, okay, give us really hard evidence. Then came the printing press. And I think the printing press, and I'll come to the Twitter thing. Printing press was the first Twitter for us. Really messed things up for us, man. I mean, obviously the white man fuck things up for us completely. But when the printing press came in, the Ahmadi community, the Christian community, not as much, the Hindu community, a lot, the Shia community, somewhat, the Sunni community, especially the Sunni community and the Ahmadi community, and Hindus, Christian, Hindu, Ahmadi, and Sunni, sorry, Sunni community, ne itni kitabe chhapi, which were so inflammatory, that became so rhetorical, that became so sectarian, and that divide and conquer was chal raha tha Britannia ki taraf se. I don't know ke peeche se wo, what strategy they were deploying, but we saw a spike of this idea that you said something offensive, now I will write something offensive, and ultimately someone is so offensive that I'll go ahead and kill you. Because Ilmuddin is not the only case. That's a popular case. There were other cases of extrajudicial killing that happened. The escalation, the first and foremost, happened with the printing press in South Asia. There were other reasons as well. The fact that there was a strong community that challenged traditional orthodox Sunni theology was one of them. But the printing press really helped bring the worst out of them. But now you have the internet.
But is it also that the printing press did that, or... is the conspiracy theorist in you thinking ki ye British kutte ke bacche jo hain, they probably had a hand in it?
I think like academics constantly do say, as a rule of thumb, one of their strategies documented is divide and rule. But I don't know ye iske sath connect kis tarah karta hai. But I do know pre-printing press and post-printing press, things looked very different. And this offensive material, when it's in text and the way they were responding, I mean, I remember reading a book. It was Ahmadi community ki taraf se, unki leadership ki taraf se thi. And it wrote lanat, I think 3,000 times. You keep rotating, it says lanat, 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 lanat. I mean, you know, if printing press na hota, to you probably would have gotten tired writing in his hand and doing like 10,000 copies. It really brings the worst out of you, brought the worst out of them, out of the sectarian, also brought the most beautiful things out of us, because the printing press allowed us, you know, these beautiful fiction and non-fiction and poetry that we read. Same with the internet. So if I draw a parallel to that, the reason I say we are at a crossroad, ye baat nahi hai ki report nahi hota tha. Baat ye hai, now you have, I recently made this illustration that your hashtag is a crosshair. I made a song as well. Ke you can have a crosshair on someone by just having the right hashtag, and we've been seeing that.
Yeah.
Technology ki wajah se aap now a man like a full on misogynist typical caricature banda soch lo. Khalil ur Rahman ka young version samajh lo, right? Khalil ur Rahman ka young version jamiyat ka PU mein hai, watches porn, loves Batman, at the same time thinks cinema is haram, all of those things, the ultimate contradiction, really into women who look modern but hates them, wants them, can't have them, the whole thing.
Yeah. Hate masturbation.
So he's sitting across a woman, and that woman talks about her agency, and she talks about feminism, whatever. He is not gonna be able to say those things. He's not gonna be able to say those things that he says online. Something that the screen allows you to do, to say the most vile things, including tum to wajibul qatl ho, that people don't say screen ke bahar.
Yeah.
Ab uski hazar wajah hai, and people have said it's not a Pakistani phenomenon, it's a phenomenon across the world, which is why Twitter, mostly Twitter, Facebook phir bhi thoda sa kam hota hai, has really become a place, a technology, and weaponized Islam, weaponized ishq e rasool ka jo combination hai, it's really escalating things. And if we don't, like, I'm not a conspiracy theorist. I'm very usually my claims, but I feel like this is the time. Like, if we don't really push for something, relax, easy ho jao, including talking to the tech companies. Like, I was in a conversation with Facebook at 1 p.m. trying to explain to them, bade aram se contextualizing ke bhai, aapka First Amendment and aapka America ka idea of freedom of speech bahut mukhtalif hai. Lekin agar idhar koi bol de ke shahzad ne birthday banayi Abu Jahl ki, to ye gaya.
Mera naam lena bahut zaruri tha aapka.
I mean, imagine someone cuts this trim.
Shahzad Roy
saab. I mean, kya unka acche bhale aadmi hai aaj.
Ha, to main acha bhala nahi hu.
I don't know you that well. I said
Shahzad Roy because who would? I mean, if somebody even goes to murder him and looks at his face, it's so beautiful. It's so kiss.
I know.
Koi kar hi nahi sakta. Jo jitna bhi extremist ho, I don't think anybody can murder Shahzad Roy. So he's safe.
He's safe. Okay, from now on, whenever we bus ke samne kabhi bhi phekna ho,
let's not test this theory though.
Okay, agreed. But ye jo inki policy corporations ka bhi masla hai, lekin we need to, and that's why it's some of our projects that we're doing, history ka this fictional film, the second film, which is very much about this genre that I'm defining as cyber khilafat. Cyberpunk is Shahr-e Tabassum, cyberpunk log keh rahe the, but I wanted to call it cyber khilafat because while it is influenced by the ideas of cyberpunk, it is very much, it's a Pakistani Muslim lens of our anxieties of what happens when technology, corporations, capitalism, consumerism, and weaponized Islam, weaponized honor all merge together and are systemically used against the masses. And this second film is not set in the future, is also exploring some of this mob violence things, because I'll tell you the premise of the film because the film is abhi Tinder ban kiya government ne, right? Mm. So it's really funny. We're going to release this teaser.
Bahut personally affect hua main.
I'm sure. Don't worry. Hang in there. Hamare mutabik, there's a replacement of a Tinder. It's a Tinder for muftis in this film. The premise is there's an app which is a Tinder for muftis where you swipe right for wajibul qatl and you swipe left for mafi. That's the premise of the film. And children get addicted to this app because there is an ajar board, and the more swipe rights you've got, you enter the ghazi board. And it's a black comedy, absurd kind of film which follows the life of a child as he tries to go into the ajar board. It's a short film, animated film, and it is influenced by all of our experience of the past 10 years, not just about blasphemy, just in general. Nationalism, ghaddari, kuch bhi bol do, to ye ho, to wo ho. The way internet and screens have made it easy to turn the phone into a gun and point at someone else without thinking too much of the consequences. So I'm very interested in Pakistan coming up with stories, fictional as well as documented, that explores this, because now is the time. Unhone bade meticulously, by unhone, I mean obviously not to otherize them, a particular ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल बड़े मेटिकुलसली नैरेटिव मैन्युफैक्चर किया है. We need to not only unravel it, deconstruct it, destroy it, but also like kadam barha ke kuch baat karna shuru kare. Not only just critique, but also intervention possibilities. So the documentary is going to be one of those things that we're doing. Swipe is the name of the second film that's going to come out. Sharat Tabassum was one attempt of it. And there's a history channel called Hashia, jo hum shuru kar rahe hain, inshallah, which uska pehla season hai on intergenerational trauma. In which we're going to look at how the white man did what he did, and colonialism or sara jo istemari nizam hai, railway ka nizam, jamhooriyat, all of those myths. So it's going to be very much like TED Ed for Pakistani community. Like Shahri Pakistan jo hamara civic education ka, this is for history, but with a much more aggressive viewpoint. As one of our teammates said, that to tell the story of the bullet as well as the story of the chest. Okay, how do you, what do you do when two histories collide, and what do you do when the story starts not from the Gora invaded the continent, but that the Native American attacked them? What do you do when the story does not start from that the African continent is a failure, but that the British created that? So those ke secondly se jab shuru karte hain na baat to baat kharab ho jati hai. Firstly kya hua tha? So we're gonna that's the principle of Hashia, and the first season is intergenerational trauma. We're gonna look at Jallianwala Bagh ki animated enactments, 1953 anti-Ahmadi violence and 1971 Bangladesh separation, and around that we'll have animated explainers that give theoretical frameworks jisse aap usko samajh saken behtar taur par. To agar hum istemai nizam ke upar ek animation banayenge, इस्तेमाई निज़ाम, ब्यूरोक्रेसी, तालीम, फिर उसके बाद जाके हम जलियांवाला बाग का ट्रॉमेटिक इंसिडेंट समझाएंगे, सो दैट यू हैव एन एकेडमिक, समवर एकेडमिक, बिकॉज दिस इज समझो का मुकदमा जो कासमी साहब का है उसका डाइल्यूटेड वर्जन, वेरी सिंप्लीफाइड, एंड देन शो एन एनिमेटेड इनएक्टमेंट ऑफ एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दैट. सो दैट्स द आइडिया ऑफ हाशिया.
ये चीज़ें समझना बहुत ज़रूरी हैं इंटर जनरेशनल ट्रामा की. जिस तरह आप बात कर रहे हैं कि आजकल अमेरिका में ये गुफ्तगू हो रही होती है कि ब्लैक पीपल से कि यू नो अगर कोई वाइट सुप्रीमेसिस्ट इस तरह की बात करे कि भाई तुम क्या स्लेवरी की बात कर रहे हो, तुम तो 20 साल पहले पैदा हुए हो. इट्स इंटरजेनरेशनल, दे आर लिविंग विद द लेगेसी ऑफ स्लेवरी, इट्स ऑन देयर, इट्स लिटरली ऑन देयर बॉडीज. तो इवन इन पाकिस्तान अगर हम बात करते हैं कि हम इतने पिच फॉक्स लेके फॉरन खड़े हो जाते हैं, वेयर थिंग्स लाइक मशल खान हैपन, वेयर आपने जो अभी स्वाइप का जिक्र किया है, इट्स वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग बिकॉज मेरा दिल काफी टूटा था रिसेंटली व्हेन अब ये थोड़ा इग्नोरेंस कह लें, थोड़ा बायस कह लें, एक परसेप्शन फिर भी होती है, या एटलीस्ट आप सोचते हैं कि कुछ इदारे या कुछ स्कूल में जो बच्चे पढ़ रहे हैं वो बेहतर होंगे. एक आपकी मेंटल इमेज बनती है कि भाई प्रो मुमताज कादरी रैली हो रही है, दे लुक अ सर्टन वे. तो अभी कुछ दिन पहले या कुछ हफ्ते पहले 16-17 साल के HSN LGS के बच्चे लिटरली किसी को मरवाने के चक्कर में थे हैशटैग के, और खुद वो 3-4 दिन बाद दे वर लाइक नहीं नहीं आप सब ठंडे हो जाएं, इट्स फाइन, because they realized कि ये हमने क्या ड्रैगन निकाला है बाहर. एंड द थिंग इज यू डोंट सी ऑन ऑनलाइन व्हेन यू आर हैशटैगिंग समथिंग, इट्स एन एब्स्ट्रैक्ट कॉन्सेप्ट, यू आर नॉट पुलिंग अ ट्रिगर इन फ्रंट ऑफ अ ह्यूमन बीइंग, यू आर नॉट. एंड मे बी एट 16 यू डोंट रियलाइज हाउ रियल दैट पॉसिबिलिटी इज, कि अगर आप एक हैशटैग किसी पे लगा देते हैं, दैट्स इनफ फॉर वन पर्सन टू डू इट. एंड I know she's changed her opinion slightly on it, but Meher Bukhari really contributed to Salman Taseer's murder.
She did. Man, that's the sad part. We wrote this film, I wrote it like a year and a half ago, and we were making this film. And jab hum last mahine mein aaya, achanak laga ki ek second, this is not fiction, ye hamare samne ho raha hai. Like, people are doing exactly what we're saying. It's just the cases are a little less absurd because we're being absurdist. And Meher Bukhari pretty much did exactly what you said she did as well. And I don't know if necessarily, because these kids are very savvy, man. I don't know. I think there's something about, because adults are doing the same. They're using those hashtags that they wouldn't say it in person. Meher Bukhari did it in front of a camera, but it khulke. But a lot of these people who use these hashtags, I mean, I'm pretty sure, because you have all kinds of people on your podcast and you made the mistake of having me as well. You have comments which पर जो ऐसे होंगे जो इन पर्सन कोई आपको आके नहीं बोलेगा, बहुत मुश्किल होगा कि आप पब्लिक में बैठे हुए एक बंदा गुजरेगा वो दिल में सोच लेगा लेकिन वो आके नहीं बोलेगा कि यार ये हो और ये हो तुम्हारे साथ ये होना चाहिए. बट द स्क्रीन, समथिंग अबाउट दैट स्क्रीन दैट ब्रिंग्स सम ऑफ आवर वर्स्ट इंस्टिंक्ट्स आउट ऑफ अस. ये वही वाली बात है. आई ऑफन टेल माय टीम मेंबर्स द एम्प्लॉइज, आई लाइक टू कॉल द एम्प्लॉइज, के व्हेनेवर यू वांट टू हैव अ कन्वर्सेशन विद मी, इफ यू फील लाइक यू कैन ओनली व्हाट्सएप दैट कन्वर्सेशन टू मी, दैट यू कैन ओनली से थ्रू द स्क्रीन, then we need to talk about that, not the conversation but about that feeling, ki why do you feel you can only say it through WhatsApp, like I'm doing something wrong that you need a screen between us to say it. So let's first talk about that. That screen really, I'm not like a tech phobe person, but something about this screen, it takes us, our humanity away, it mutes us, it does things, man. It has done terrible things to us, it has done irreparable damage.
बचपन में इमोशनली स्टंटेड था. आई डिड ऑल माय ब्रेकअप्स ओवर पहला ब्रेकअप तो आई थिंक आई डिड ओवर ईमेल. सब्जेक्ट लाइन थी उसकी, डोंट क्राई बिकॉज़ इट्स ओवर, स्माइल बिकॉज़ इट हैपेंड. टू बी फेयर आई वाज 16 और उस टाइम हम इतने कूल 16 ईयर ओल्ड्स नहीं थे. तो
आई मीन व्हेन आई वाज 16 तो आई थॉट म्यूजिक वाज हराम एंड लाइक यू वर हराम एंड ऑल ऑफ दोस थिंग्स वर हराम बिकॉज़ मैं जमीयत में था. So you were doing better than I was. And my MSN email address, right, couple of years later, I fell in love. I married after a while. I fell in love with my us time pe, the person that I wanted to marry. And I started discovering music. So I made my email address, Cornnation81. Cornnation, that was my username. Corn was a new metal band at that time.
Yeah, K-O-R-N.
उल्टा आर के साथ एंड रॉकज़िला एंड सो या मैन वी हम सारे एक ही उससे. बट आई हैवंट ब्रोकन विद एनीवन लाइक दैट, सो दैट्स यू मैन, दैट्स ऑल यू. आई लव इट. दिस कैन बी अ कन्फेशनल, यू नो, इन व्हिच वी टॉक अबाउट द लेमेस्ट थिंग्स वी हैव डन. टू बी ऑनेस्ट दो, इन प्रिंसिपल आई एग्री विद दिस, के डोंट क्राई अबाउट दैट बट स्माइल बिकॉज़ ऑफ दैट.
आई नो,
बट इन अ या
दैट्स नॉट हाउ आई मेंट इट. आई मेंट इट लाइक, गर्ल आई एम लीविंग.
Oh man. Yeah.
It's okay. She had the last laugh. She married my best friend. So
oh dear. Oh, we're going there.
What is there a story?
No, like I mean, go ahead. I mean, it's like you just dropped that very haram se.
At this point, mere podcast listeners know all my demons. I've shared a lot more.
Okay. But,
mm-hmm. So even in coming back to that social media printing press idea, it has weaponized, or it's like हमें समझ भी नहीं आ रही कि कोई किसी ने आपको AK-47 दे दिया and you're a caveman जिसने language भी नहीं invent की और उनको AK-47 मिल गई है. That's us with Twitter and Facebook. हमें समझ भी नहीं आ रही and credit to you for approaching them, but Facebook ने बर्मा में genocide करवा दिया, उनको कोई नहीं फर्क पड़ा. Was it Burma or was it Myanmar? One of the two.
Myanmar, yeah.
So, to unko us cheez se koi farak nahi pada. So, I doubt they'll intervene or grow a conscience right now.
Yeah, that's the thing, man. I've done a lot of consultation with them in trying to explain to them ke, like, if they'd ask ke, acha, Qadiani bolne mein kya hai kisi ko, you know, galat hai at most. But that's not illegal. I would say it's structured in a way that no matter how good the people are, it's driven obviously by profit and it's driven all obviously by shares that India mein zyada ahem hai unke liye, Pakistan nahi hai. And it's a cult as well. Everybody worships Mark Zuckerberg. I've been to their office multiple times and Mark says, I was like, oh my God, like, do you even remember what your name is? But most importantly, he's built a thing and these people have built a thing that they didn't know will turn into such a beast. Jo elections kar raha hoga, and we have no idea what to do with it.
He wanted to read no girls in his college.
Yeah, yeah. And now, I don't know. I think it's important, freedom of speech ke issues. I know Twitter ke progressive communities also split. You'd have very American constitutional lawyers like Vikas Mir and Even Salman Raja Saab, abhi jo recent issue hua tha, deplatforming, when it comes to freedom of expression, we have a divided audience. And I like that. You've got people on one hand claiming ke we need to look at a critical eye on what does freedom of expression mean. And I think Pakistan ko thoda sa, especially human rights community, ko needs to have a really good hard look. I need to have a good hard look at ourselves. Ke our elitist, white, a historical idea of human rights needs to go out of the window. Dr. Sabah Mahmood, God bless her. I was going to hand this over to someone and do a PhD under her in University of Berkeley. The ultimate Pakistani academic, the ultimate anthropologist. She wrote a book, Minority Report, jismein wo bayan karti hai ke human rights ke jo declarations the, unke likhne wale kaun the. And a lot of them were, for example, missionaries were one of the people involved in the freedom of religion and freedom of conscience wala idea, because they wanted to go and turn people in Africa and Asia into Christians without there being any consequences. So history aur tareekh ko janna ke mazhab ka isme kya kirdaar raha hai, human rights mein colonialism ka kya kirdaar raha hai, finance ka kya kirdaar raha hai, istemali nizam ko aur musallat karne ka kya nizam raha hai. And also the community, I believe in all of those rights, but the community, it also ke hamari jo fundamental rights chapter 2 hai constitution ka, wo kisne likhe the bhai, kab aaye the, kaun si jo discussion hui thi, kaun si conversation hui thi, can we read about it? We can read about it, about the American Constitution, which is why, as much as they're a terrible system in many ways, their Bill of Rights is incredible. Yeah. It has, because it comes from a place of ladaiyan and conversations. Hamari fundamental rights kisne likhe hain, chhape the hotel room mein, do teen babus gaye the and they wrote something down from their elitist education. What happened? And why weren't people involved, more people involved? Okay, ab likha gaya, ab logo ko bataye to sahi ke just because you signed on a convention, why should people care? I think people should care, absolutely. Why should they care? Hamare apne indigenous local idioms mein samjhaye, which Shahri Pakistan tries to do, ke ye rights aate kahan se hain aur hamare liye ahem kyun hain. Social contract aur ye ahd jo hai hamari zaman mein samjhaye kya hai, kyun hai. Samjhaye bagair, unko resources diye bagair, main to chalo, I was lucky ke shuru to main hua tha Crescent Model School mein, and mera, I was going down the same lane, jamiyat se hote hue matric kiya, I was going to go become an engineer, and jamaat mein probably I could have seen myself being in a leadership position right now, but I fell in love with someone who was very progressive, and all of a sudden I was exposed to all of these things, and I was privileged.
Sahi kehte na, MSN bacche bigad hai, bilkul sahi baat hai.
MSN se pyar nahi hua tha, mujhe debate ke through hua tha, and I'm divorced now, so you know, so there's that. You dropped one, I dropped one.
But you found yourself.
Oh yeah, absolutely. I mean, God bless her. I mean, I found music. I found that I wanted to express myself. I found that I had a fire in me. I found that I knew what I wanted to do with the rest of my life. And I found what love can do, that there's nothing more powerful than kindness and compassion and love in all of this. But my thing is ki aapne convention sign kar diya hai, but udhar jo Mumtaz Qadri ka beta hai, uski kitni zimmedari hai, when he har jalse mein wo upar hota hai, usko bata rahe hote hain ki ek hi saza, sartan se juda, gaane unke bani ja rahe hain, we are failing them.
Mujhe lagta hai kuch uncles bahane se unki puppy le lete hain jinko Mumtaz Qadri
pasand. Yes, I mean, yeah, as dark as it is, who knows, but the point is, preaching at them is what the white people used to do.
Yeah.
Instead of preaching at the community at large, like my mother was on the other side of the Aurat March. I was on the other side of the Aurat March. Wo Jamaat Islami mein, she's an important worker. And Jamaat ne bhi Aurat March nikali thi. We had a conversation about it at the end of the day. We went back home. It's very difficult for her to, but she loves me. She embraced the idea. Music unke liye haram hai, main musician hu. Blasphemy law ki tahaffuz ke liye wo jalse mein nikalti hain, main uski opposite mein nikalta hun. But it is possible for us to have a conversation about it. And she does think now, and most of the Jamaati leaders that I've talked to now believe that there's something wrong with the law. I mean, I'll take names. Fareed Paracha believes there's something wrong with the law. Samia Qazi, the daughter of Qazi Hussain Ahmed, thinks there's something wrong with the law. You have a lot of, even Naam Mere Guzar Rahe, but a lot of Muftis, obviously, Ammar Khan Nasir, Mufti Muhammad Zahid, Zahid al-Rashdi Saab, I'm just distributing risk here. Mushtaq Ahmed, the head of Sharia Academy in IIU, Islamic International University, huge following on Facebook, wrote a paper, published it, Angrezi mein translation bhi hai, Urdu mein bhi translation hai. There, Arafat Mazhar is one small person who just throws a fancy love istemal kar sakta hai, or people of all kind of beard lengths and religious beliefs have said it in various forms, some publicly, some privately. We just need to be able to find a way ke bhai hamari vocabulary same kaise ho sakti hai. Aap us tarah baat karna cha rahe ho, main is tarah baat karna cha raha hu. So can we talk? Is it possible to negotiate? And uske liye pehle hame aapas mein baat karni padegi. I remember the first time, it was in 2010, I was very young, and Taimur Rahman, mind na karna, good man, matlab, he's always been kind to me. But I remember Center for Democracy tha, Rafi Alam saab ne bulaya mujhe, he knew ke I was researching. And we were processing grief, Salman Taseer's son was there. And I remember everybody was talking about, okay.
Which one, the good one, the bad something. One?
the good one. Never met the bad one yet. But but actually the good/bad one, to be fair. I mean, his gender politics is terrible. The other guy's capitalist politics is terrible. These days, it's hard to find a person who something is not, probably Mera something is terrible as well. But he was there, and there were these 15, 16 people. Wohi shakle maine agle 10 saal dekhi in the human rights community anyway. Very good people, intelligent people. And I heard all of these things and they sounded so alien to me because obviously mera background mukhtalif tha. Pehle main jamiyat mein tha, uske baad maine academia ki bahut sari kitabein khud padhna shuru ki, but background computer science mein tha. Mujhe nahi pata tha WAF ki tareekh aur human rights ki 80 ki dahai aur 60 ki tareekh mein Pakistan ki tareekh. And all of it sounded alien to me, and I figured if it sounds so alien to me, how alien must it sound when you say it on television to everyone else? So I stood up and I gave like this 20-minute summary of the research that I gave to you. And I remember there was this lady, she started crying. She's like, thank you, because it resolved some of my crisis. And I didn't think she was even a practicing Muslim. That was how much I was boxing people in. And turns out she was. And she was like, thank you so much. And then Taimur Rahman, I remember, Taimur, if you're watching this, I don't know if you remember this or not. But he was like, main to maarne ke liye taiyar nahi, itna seedha saada jhoot bol diya, bas ye bhi jhoot bol diya, ye bhi jhoot bol diya, itna aasan kaise ho sakta hai, itna khul ke kaise koi jhoot bol sakta hai. And also that's not our agenda. Our agenda is, how do we resist using, and then chahe aap Marx ki zaman istemal kare, chahe aap liberal human rights ki istemal kare, my contention is this. Chahe it's my friends at HRCP, jahan main jata hun, these are people who've done a billion times more blood, sweat into this. These are people who've seen 80s and went through it. My contention remains ke hame thora tarikhi taur pe cheez ko dekhna padega, hame thora empathize bhi karna padega ab the anxieties of the right wing leadership, ki kya hai unko masla, khauf hai kya? Because they are acting like the majority is acting like they're scared, the same way the neo-Nazis type white supremacists come from a place of fear. James Baldwin kehta tha na ke asal mein to wo dare hue hain.
Yeah,
like what do you do? It's like if I use James Baldwin's imagery, he says for them radical ideas like Jahmaidi, like okay, blasphemy law may be wrong, feminism wagaira wagaira, agar hum iski baat karte hain, to it's like they wake up in the morning, all of a sudden the sun just sun kahan se nikalta hai Shahzad?
Land the of the rising sun is Japan, right? So east
ha, east ke bajaye west se nikal jaye. That's how all of a sudden they dissociating and disorienting it is for them. Their whole world and identity, and all of a sudden the only thing they can turn to is violence. That is where we need to tap in. We need to empathize and understand, not over empathize, not like Hannibal season wala empath banke become friends with the psychopath. No, at least understand for the sake of the children that chahe wo LGS ke bacche ho, chahe Mumtaz Qadri ka beta ho. Bhai, at the end of the day, at the end of two fathers died. सलमान तासीर डाइड, कादरी डाइड, उसका भी बेटा और सलमान तासीर के बेटे भी, दोनों के लिए मेरी सिंपथीज है. उसका बच्चा इज गोना ग्रो अप विदाउट एनी एक्सपोजर टू ट्रूथ, व्हाट आई बिलीव इज द ट्रूथ, and he's going to probably grow up to into a Mumtaz Qadri, a much more manufactured Mumtaz Qadri. How are we going to look out for him? How are we going to look out for those schools jahan pe national anthem ki jagah chote chote bacche bolte hain and I'll enact it. Jo kuch ta khair shul ki ek hi saza shaitan shuda shaitan shuda. How are we going to save those kids jo TikTok bana rahe the Asia Bibi ke time pe, ki they took a doll and they took it to a tree and they रस्सी से उसके गले के गिर बांध के दरख्त से उसको लटकाया एंड देन दे सेलिब्रेटेड. चिल्ड्रन, छोटे छोटे बच्चे एंड खुश हो रहे थे. क्लियरली दिस इज इन द बाइनरी, ओ दीज आर इविल किड्स, वो शैतान के बच्चे नहीं हैं. दीज आर चिल्ड्रन जो हमने अपने एलीट बबल में रहते हुए, आप ये सोचें, एंड दिस इज नॉट मी बिकॉज आई थिंक इट्स स्टिल अ वर्क इन प्रोग्रेस, आई एम, दिस इज नॉट मी ब्रैगिंग, बट शहरी पाकिस्तान से पहले कोई प्लेटफॉर्म ऐसा नहीं था जो ये बता दे आइन क्या होता है उर्दू में, बुनियादी हुकूक क्या होते हैं उर्दू में. एवरीथिंग वाज इन इंग्लिश. यूएन आता है, यूएन वुमन, अन वुमन, अन हिट मी, एवरीथिंग वाज इन इंग्लिश. एड एजेंसी के पास जाएगी, वो अंग्रेजी में करके भेज देंगे, क्या फायदा, वो ऑलरेडी एग्जिस्ट करता है. उर्दू में, लोकल लैंग्वेजेस में कोई मटीरियल ही मौजूद नहीं था. वी हैवंट बॉदर्ड टू टॉक अबाउट द बेसिक बिल्डिंग ब्लॉक्स ऑफ अ कन्वर्सेशन. वी रीच सिंपली टू द एंड वन से के ये ऑफ है, ये ऑफ है, ये ऑफ है, चेंज योर माइंड यू बारबेरियंस. And yes, they're barbaric, but I'm not defending them. But I'm saying, sabse pehle, as a family, as a community, you and I, we need some imminent critique and a different methodology. Because clearly, what we've been trying over the past four decades, three decades, chahe wo NGOs ho, chahe wo civil societies ho, we're not working. It's not working. All across the world, it's not working. So we need to, I believe, look at people like Dr. Sabah Mahmood, people like Qasim Zaman, study the academy. The modern academy, you know, usually someone like me would say the academy is an ivory tower. It's not. I believe the modern academy is really ahead of its time when it comes to Pakistani issues. Rumi Saab, University of Berkeley, UBC, British Columbia. He's written a book on really, really relevant for Pakistan. Sabah Mahmood ko padhe, Qasim Zaman Saab ko padhe. All of them have written about South Asia, ulama, authority kis tarah establish hoti hai, who do people believe, why do they believe them in matters of Islam in Pakistan. Logo ko pata hona chahiye Deoband kya hai, Barelvi hai kya. Log kehte hain madrasa jo hai na udhar jo hai na bade extremist hote hain. Nahi bhai, grammar school mein bhi hote hain, Punjab university mein zyada hote hain madrason se. Kyun hote hain? Madrason mein kabhi gaye bhi ho kya aap ye claim kar rahe ho? Dars-e-Nizami jo hai na uske andar physics aur maths dalne ki zarurat hai, sab theek ho jayega. No, Dars-e-Nizami ke bare mein kisi ko pata bhi nahi unka syllabus kya hai. लेकिन ये जरूर पता है सिलेबस जो है वो ठीक कैसे होगा. That's arrogance, man.
या आप किसी एक इंसान की तरफ निशाना कर रहे हैं, इशारा आपका?
नहीं 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 नहीं, मेरा इशारा सिर्फ एक तरफ नहीं है. मेरा इशारा तो पीछे जाता है एहसन इकबाल तक का. बिकॉज आई रिमेम्बर ही वॉज ऑन अ कमिटी विच वॉज वर्किंग ऑन, बिकॉज हर हुकूमत बनाती है कि जी मदरसा का रिफॉर्म. एंड आई आस्क्ड हिम, सो व्हाट आर योर प्लान्स? Because they, what I feel they should do is Dars-e-Nizami ki tradition mein hi jaate huye, A, make it mandatory that they read the constitution because they're jurists. A, madrasa system does not need to be abolished. It needs to stay. B, it needs to be reimagined the way Jordan has done it, Morocco has done it very successfully. C, they study social contract as a conquest treaty. Imagine that. You're a student and you're being told गैर मुसलमान को तुमने कब्जा कर लिया है, अब उसकी ये हैसियत है. दैट्स ऑल यू नो. यू डोंट नो व्हाट अ सिटीजन इज. एंड देन लेटर द कोर्ट कॉल्स यू एट अ ज्यूरिस्ट कंसल्ट. द पार्लियामेंट राइट्स टू यू, पीपल आस्क यू क्वेश्चंस एज अ ज्यूरिस्ट. ऑब्वियसली द आंसर्स दैट यू विल गिव, जो उसके प्रेमिसेस होंगे, विल बी बेस्ड ऑन कॉन्क्वेस्ट ट्रीटीज एंड नॉट आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट यू नीड टू डू, इट्स सच कॉमन सेंस, इज मेक इट मैंडेटरी फॉर देम टू रीड द सेकंड चैप्टर, द सोशल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट दैट एग्जिस्ट दैट वी ऑल अग्री ऑन, सो दैट द पोजीशंस दैट दे गिव आर बेस्ड ऑन दोस प्रेमिसेस. इट्स नॉट देयर फॉल्ट दिस पार्ट इफ दे हैव नेवर बीन टॉट दैट, इफ व्हाट दे आर बीइंग टॉट इज दिस. नाउ दैट्स पार्ट ऑफ अ क्रिटिक ऑफ Dars-e-Nizami. या फिर Dars-e-Nizami में खैराबादी स्कूल ऑफ लॉजिक हुआ करता था, विच वॉज वे अहेड ऑफ एनीथिंग व्हाट डॉक्टर परवेज हुदबॉय कैन इवन फैदम. उनके सर के ऊपर से चले जाए लॉजिशियनशिप जो एग्जिस्ट किया करती थी इन दरस निज़ामी. डॉक्टर असद अहमद साहब हैज रिटन अ लॉट ऑन दिस, ही हैड एन आर्गुमेंट विद हिम ऑन दिस एज वेल. वी हैड इनक्रेडिबल लॉजिशियंस. I have nothing to do with Deoband Bareilvi. For me, no interest. But as a historian, they were incredible logicians. Even when they had to give a fatwa to kill, their logicianship was incredible. Bring that back. Use some of the... But physics or maths, padhadenge, modern education, padhadenge, to theek ho jayega. That's what Ehsan Iqbal said. Any suggestion that I see comes from someone who has not even bothered. It would take you 2 hours. It would take you 2 hours. Imagine the arrogance. You want to keep on saying that madrasa curriculum is messed up, but you're not going to take 2 hours to see what the actual curriculum is. Tell me why they should trust us. Why should the madrasa students and the stakeholders trust the civil rights, civil society that does not bother to look at their pedagogy, that does not bother to look at their means of teaching, that does not bother to look at their texts and the curriculum before they reach the conclusion that the curriculum is off. Off hair, that's, I agree with you. But A, the recommendations people have been giving is terrible because it's not premised on a real understanding. Or nahi to ek kitab hai Ibrahim Musa sahab ki, Dr. Ibrahim Musa, University of Notre Dame mein hote hain. Deoband hote the ek zamane mein, South Africa se the. He's a Pakistani, I think. His kitab Badr is Madrasa hi padh lo. Ek chota sa kitab cha hai Dars-e Nizami ka, wo padh lo. If just try and understand some basic realities. Aapka janaza idhar se nikalta hai, aapki shaadiyan ye log karate hain, aap bande hue ho. I don't care if you're an agnost, you don't even know ki mere kya beliefs hain. Doesn't matter. Ye aapka fabric, aapke muashre ka hissa hai. Agar aapne iske bare mein baat karni hai to iski tareekh aur iski at least basic realities ka pata hona chahiye, so that you don't sound like an arrogant colonizer to them,
white savior.
Yeah, ke bhai, let me tell you, civilization beta ye hoti hai. And even if what you're saying is correct, you're going to sound like that.
Aap jo baat keh rahe hain wo 100% sahi hai. Iske, I mean, you've really pulled on great multiple threads throughout that rant, if I may call it that. So, but jo do sabse bade stumbling block hain, ek to jis tarah humne discussion shuru kiya tha, birth creation blasphemy law, ke jo aapko bata rahe hain mazhab kya hai ya curriculum kya hai, क्या उनको खुद भी पता है जो पढ़ाने वाले हैं, क्या उन्होंने खुद भी पढ़ा हुआ है. बी, अगर हम पाकिस्तान स्पेसिफिक हो जाएं, स्पेसिफिक पावर इंटरेस्ट टू नॉट लेट द मासेस नो व्हाट देयर राइट्स आर.
अग्रीड ऑन बोथ फ्रंट्स. नंबर वन, द पीपल हु हैव बीन लाइंग, दे डू नो व्हाट इट इज, दे डिलिबरेटली लाइंग. देन देयर इज द सेकंड टियर, देयर आर पीपल. मुझे याद पड़ता है जामिया अशरफिया के मैं दाउल इफ्ता में गया था. यू नो देयर बुक्स आर रियली एक्सपेंसिव. If they have 8 texts in their curriculum, they'll never, unne zindagi bhar wo kitabein nahi dekhi honi. 8 volume ki kitab ho, total 6,000 safhe ho, 25,000 to 30,000 rupaye ki kitab ho. Imagine, unki library mein ek hi mil jaye to bahut bahut mushkil ho se. So students never are able to read the actual text. They read manuals, ya phir they read orally, because it was meant to be a one-on-one oral tradition. It wasn't meant to be like the white person's way of education of a classroom setting, which it turned out to be. But I remember going there with a scanned book, because these texts are now available online. And I also gave them a proposition, okay, how about everyone has a 6,000 rupee ka tablet and uske andar everything's available. They can search Sabir Rasool and they'll find everything. And the head mufti over there like lost his marbles, because you know, you're democratizing knowledge and you don't want that. But I remember I went to a chota mufti first, and he looked at my MacBook Pro us time pe, and he was like, ye iske andar kitab ye sahi hogi? And I showed him jiske andar likha hua tha ki tauhin e saagza maut nahi hai wagaira wagaira, and he was looking at it and he was like, nahi. And then I remember the look of confusion, and then he went, it's like main apni volume leke aata hu. He found the volume, he looked at it, usme bhi ye likha hua tha. And then people gathered around him, and then the head mufti uske paas leke gaye. He knew. And there was a look of betrayal. Now, main interpret kar raha hun, there was a look of betrayal in the students ki, ke ek second, you, that's not what you told us. And he said, ke, lekin ye maamla jo hai, bahut fikhi maamla hai, aapka maamla nahi hai. Property aur shaadi ke baare mein koi question hai to poochhein. Because obviously that's the only thing that I should care about, right? Ki meri property kitni milni hai mujhe, aur talaak hui hai ki nahi hui. But to your question of the 2 points, dekhein, if you want to call yourself, if you're taking on the responsibility, if you have a messiah complex, if you do think it, you are the human rights community. I am, my friends are, all my friends are. So this critique is very imminent. It's very inwards. I say the same to all of my peers in person as well. If we want to take on that responsibility, then resistance must mean ke jo hame chah raha hai us knowledge se rokne ko hum wo diwar tode. Though, no, the teachers, even the teachers don't know what their syllabus, they know what the syllabus is, but they don't have access to the text of that syllabus, which is why, you know what happens. I remember one of my first employees was Alim Fazil. He was a graduate from one of the madrasas. He tells me a story. He used to be in Sipa Sahaba. And he was one of the researchers on the book that you'll read. And he told me, ke humare paas kitabe to hoti nahi thi. So one day, class mein aaye teacher aur unne cassette mein sunana shuru kar diya ahle tashi community ki taraf se inflammatory statements. And jo jo cheeze maine suni Hazrat Aisha ke bare mein, Hazrat Abu Bakr ke bare mein, to mere to rongte khade ho gaye. उन्होंने बंद किया और सबसे पूछा कि सिपाही कौन बनना चाहता है. एंड इज लाइक इमेजिन करें अरफात भाई के, आई मीन ऑब्वियसली ही वाज़न्ट सेइंग इमेजिन, क्या आप सोचें कि उस कैफियत में उन्होंने सबसे पूछा कि, एंड ही इज गिविंग देम अ पर्पस कि सिपाही कौन बने, बेसिक सिपा साहबा ज्वाइन करने के लिए. इट्स लाइक मैं बनना चाहता हूँ बिकॉज, एंड दैट्स व्हाट वाज हैपनिंग इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ एक्चुअल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. आपके मोहल्ले में जो मदरसा है उधर एक यूपीएस लगवा के किताबें डाल के देख लें, हो सकता है इट माइट बी हेल्पफुल. But the question remains whether or not the madrasa needs to be abolished, whether or not the madrasa needs a new curriculum, all of those questions. I'm not giving answers to these. I'm just saying ke we are reaching conclusions without actually studying them. And we don't even have to do that extensive study. We can defer to dozens of people who've done their PhDs in these things, man. Lums mein Numan Faizi says, religious department mein someone like Numan Faizi, Ali Usman Qasmi sahab ko bada pata hai madrasa ke bare mein, Amar Khan Naz se Gujranwala mein PhD kar rahe hain, Dr. Ibrahim, he's also a Deoband, someone like Zain Maulvi who's done a brilliant work in South Asia. There are people who've done it. We need to talk to them and find out, okay, how does human rights and like tradition, not religious, of all kinds, cultural tradition, religious tradition, these idioms that do belong to us, whether or not we believe them theologically or not. How do they overlap? How do we create a language that is our own? And partly the reason I gave that example was that's often me as well. Main bade patronizing, condescending tarike se baaz dafa apne parents ko dekhta hun when they say something really extreme and like misogynistic and or religiously, and it's like, you know, I mean, you've been alive 60 years and that's still what you've arrived. And I need to then check myself, ki listen, ek privilege wo bhi hai that comes from exposure of knowledge.
Yeah.
Ek privilege wo bhi hai that comes from being able to read Foucault, that comes from being able to read Muhammad Qasim Zaman Saab, that comes from being able to discover Sabah Mahmood and being invited to Center for Democracy and meeting people like Rafi Alam Saab, talking to people like the late Asma Jahangir Sahiba. Ye saari privileges har ek ko nahi milti. So thoda kam patronizing hona, and also making you and I, if I am to say, if we're the current generation of the if we're not the 80s wale progressive community, quote unquote, and if we are fighting for human rights, which I am, then we need to find our own method of conversation. We are not bound by anyone. No one gets to tell us that the way that you fight for human rights is only this. We get to define it because there's been a lot of failure. No one's done a stellar job. Jinnah Institution, jo Shahid Rahman ke under tha, blasphemy law ke upar research karke, pata nahi kitne paise le le ke, I mean, haq banta hai, lo. Unhone jo report nikali thi, when I finally studied it, it was terrible. It was factually inaccurate. Blasphemy law pe har saal, sawai ICJ, because Reema Umar ki wajah se, because she is an excellent lawyer, vagaira vagaira. She wrote an amazing, incredible report on blasphemy law. But every next blasphemy law is a plagiarized copy of the previous blasphemy law report, 1994 se leke ab tak. Amnesty ki reports, har saal wohi cheez hoti hai, commission hoti hai, they write the same things again. And you're like, no shit, Sherlock, it violates these. I know that.
आई नो के हाँ प्रोसीजर जो है नहीं फॉलो हो रहा, आई नो मिस यूज हो रहा है, कैन वी टॉक अबाउट समथिंग मोर सब्सटेंटिव देन दैट? सो दैट्स माय कंप्लेन टुवर्ड्स मी, टुवर्ड्स अदर्स, टुवर्ड्स एवरीवन, व्हिच इज व्हाई आई वाज रियली कॉन्फ्लिक्टेड बट एक्साइटेड अबाउट चुडेल्स. Very tangent, all of a sudden.
I think वो घंटा और लग जाएगा उसमें, but I do agree with your gripe 100%. ये जो 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 critique या जो सवाल है कि लोगों लोग आवाम जाहिल हैं जिस तरह कहा जाता है, या आवाम को जाहिल रखा गया है. So what you're saying is why have we not been able to tell them what their rights are? Is that ineptitude or is that by design? कि अगर सबको rights पता चल गए, सबको एक और दुनिया पता चल गई, तो कल को जंग होती है तो ये लोग कहाँ से आएंगे? That may be a bigger fight to fight. लेकिन हम जिनसे बात कर रहे हैं या हम जिनको अपनी कम्युनिटी का हिस्सा समझते हैं, part of the reason left or right दोनों मुझे लवारिस कर चुके हैं is because sometimes I also get blamed for being an apologist. जिस तरह आपने भी बात की, अगर हम अब risk mitigation और risk distribution करते हैं, think about the worst thing that happened in Pakistan history, like or at least in our recent memory. APS का जब जिक्र आता है, it's heartbreaking. The images, I feel the entire nation has PTSD. One of the terrorists या उनके जो बयान आया था, he said, now you know how we feel जब drone attack में हमारे school के बच्चे मरते हैं. Now you know how we feel. Now this is the person who's done the worst imaginable thing in the world. You've went into a school and shot children. But to hear that person say कि यार ये तो हमारी everyday lived reality है, you also have some empathy for that person. That doesn't mean you're being an apologist for that person. That doesn't mean you're justifying their action. It just means ke dusre insaan ko agar aap sirf monster samjhenge, jis tarah even jab har dafa child abuse hota hai, hamara solution hota hai isko taang do, that's not going to solve anything, because you're just thinking ye kahin se monsters land ho chuke hain and we don't really have any structural problems. And that otherization, कि ये जाहिल लोग, इनसे कुछ भी नहीं. Even Mumtaz Qadri की जब इस्लामाबाद में धरना हुआ था, you look at the demands, most of them are economic demands. Most of them are not even religious demands.
Yeah. Fair point. I've thought about this a lot. कि my personality type में empath है and unhealthy amount of empathy sometimes, which can create boundary issues, right? So let's say I'm in an intermittent relationship, I can cause damage to that relationship by over empathizing. So I am careful, even though it may not seem like it, ke wo kaun si line hai. Misal ke taur pe, a man beats his wife up regularly, and let's say you're writing a story, and in your story you show that jab wo chota tha to he suffered from trauma the way he saw his father hit his mother regularly, and that became his destiny, whatever, right? Is tarah ki hazar kahani hai. That Joker ki jo film aayi thi, like the screenplay was terrible, the cinematography and acting was incredible, but there was a lot of interesting conversation. So I will not make a definitive statement about this idea, but that's a good way to look at it, ke when you are trying to talk about how the psychology of it, okay, how did they become who they are, what are the systematic ways in which they became who they are, wo kaun si zuban hai jo aapne istemal karni hai, aapka maqsad kya hai, aapki drive kya hai, motivation kya hai? Because I know people who would empathize to apologize as well. So what is it that differentiates them from someone who is looking for an intervention, not for what is the best way to correct systemic correction ka tarika kya hai? And there are all kinds of theories about that, and I have respect for all of them. But there are some people who thought that Joker mein, they glamorized and romanticized the same thing in Taxi Driver, Nightcrawler, anti-heroes jo hote hain, even Batman, ki trauma mil gaya ek white billionaire ko to jaake ji wo marna shuru ho jaye logo ko. So are you justifying that or not? So there must be a way to talk about this in which you, a lot of people have gone through trauma. A lot of people have gone through injustices. Terrorists are all around the world have. I would say I will look at it practically. I would look at it only practically. Okay, in order to solve the crisis, I need to know how that man was made. How to make a Mumtaz Qadri. I need to know that. I need to know what is he a symptom of, so that I can discover
the actual cancer. That's my only... When I say ke darsan azami padh to lo, it's not because I'm saying darsan azami bahut acha hai. It's because ultimately I want to know ke wo system hai kya. And also, I also don't want to be arrogant and make claims. That aside, but the only, I think, if I think about it, the way I, around it, because there is some credence to people saying ke yaar apologist baat kar rahe ho. I understand what they're saying as well. But I think if they understand, if we are all agreed that we are trying to solve a systemic issue here, we're not saying, ke, oh, I get it. You shot a whole school up because, you know, your parents were tough on you, like a very white man in America. Udhar bhi aur conversation
Fox News yahi karega. Fox News to yahi karega.
Yeah, right.
Abhi jo kar rahe.
Yeah, yeah, right. So I remember someone's doing, because people keep writing to me, there's a lot of incredible work happening. I know because people write to me when they're doing their PhDs for resources, because whenever it relates to blasphemy law. So one of the people who was working on criminal psychology with regards to blasphemy offenses. And so those are the kind of things that we need. So why do we want to understand evil and the nature of evil? We want to understand it not because we want to say, look, yehi hona tha. What else could he have done? Although Mumtaz Qadri ki bete ke baare mein main yehi bol raha hu. Ke if he grows up to do something wrong and we haven't done anything to fix that situation, then bhai, maine usko blame nahi karna. Main apne aap ko pehle blame karunga, phir usko blame karunga. Yes, people have agency, but we're also part of a machine created by a much bigger status quo. And the bigger fight is breaking that status quo and understanding how evil is not inherent to us, but evil is embedded in us by these people who want to control us. So partly we need to explain it. So yes, it matters. It matters. Even sometimes Imran Khan kabhi bhi drone ke baare mein baat kiya karta tha, people immediately went to like, yeh toh bhai apologist hai. Although wo hai, but like he had very good points. So I agree with you ke ek knee-jerk reaction har ek ka hai, mera bhi hota hai. And after that knee-jerk reaction, it is okay to sit to step back and say, maybe I was wrong. Shehzad's got a point. And I mean, that would be radical, Shehzad, the day we start next day tweeting, I thought about it. And you know what? I changed my mind. We haven't figured shit out yet. That would be radical.
Aap jo keh rahe hai na, ke for me to look at an issue, I have to be like, okay, let's read it just to understand it. मसला यही है कि जितने हम कॉन्सेप्ट और आइडियाज की बात करें जो इंसान की फितरत है एंड देयर इज अ पॉसिटी ऑफ क्यूरियोसिटी के जी इफ आई फाइंड अ 5 सेकंड क्लिप इट्स इजी फॉर मी टू लेबल यू एज सच एंड देन रिजेक्ट एवरीथिंग यू से लेट्स से मेरा स्ट्रॉस पे एक मैंने अपना बिलीफ सिस्टम बनाया है एंड मैं इस वक्त लेफ्ट की बात कर रहा हूँ ठीक है बिकॉज आई थिंक विद दिस पॉडकास्ट विल प्रोबब्ली रीच द लेफ्ट लॉट मोर तो left maybe unfortunately and I'm not talking about the academics maybe some of the social justice warriors paucity of curiosity hai ke nahi main arafat ka sara kaam dekhu uski kitabe padhu uska kaam padhu mujhe agar 10 second ki clip mil gayi it's easy for me to reject you it's easy for me to label you and then for me I am morally superior than you ab baat khatam ho gayi acha bhai ye to apologist hai अब मुझे कोई जरूरत नहीं कि मैं आपके सारा काम पढूं, समझूं कि एक्चुअली आपकी पोजीशन क्या है एक इंटेलेक्चुअल लेवल पे अपने अपने बिलीफ को क्वेश्चन करूं ये सारा प्रोसेस तो बहुत मेहनत की बात है ना बहुत आसान है कि ओ अराफात या आई डोंट रीड हिज वर्क मैन ही इज अ टेररिस्ट अपोलोजिस्ट और अनफॉर्चुनेटली इवन अगर सच्ची बात मैं आपको कहूँ कि काफी ह्यूमन राइट एक्टिविस्ट या काफी लोग जिनसे आप बात करते हैं जिनसे सुनते हैं मे बी हैड दे मेट यू व्हेन यू वर इन 10th ग्रेड उन्होंने तो आपको बोलना था ये तो मॉन्स्टर है ही इज इसका तो कोई है ही नहीं फ्यूचर अनसेवेबल दिस पर्सन विल बिकम अ टेररिस्ट एंड टिल वी डोंट हैव दैट कन्वर्सेशन एंड दैट ह्यूमन कनेक्शंस एंड यू आर इन द ग्रेट प्लेस बिकॉज़ आप दोनों दुनिया में रह चुके हैं सो यू कैन हैव दैट कन्वर्सेशन यू आर राइट के इट्स ऑलमोस्ट अ डिफरेंट लैंग्वेज दैट वी स्पीकिंग आपने वोकैबुलरी का बट आई विल से इट्स ऑलमोस्ट अ डिफरेंट लैंग्वेज दैट दे आर स्पीकिंग टू यू के आपके कॉन्सेप्ट्स का वर्ल्ड व्यू उधर है ही नहीं और आप वही कर रहे हैं जो आप कॉलोनियल वाइट सेवियर को क्रिटिसाइज करते हैं कि वो जी आके हमें सिखा रही हैं आप फिर गांव जाकर वही हरकतें करते हैं यू आर रिपीटिंग द सेम साइकिल
या आई मीन समटाइम्स आई फील लाइक आई हैव डन इट लाइक सो ग्रुप ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस दैट वी रन वन ऑफ देम इज एन एनजीओ एंड आई हैव ऑलवेज हेटेड वर्कशॉप्स राइट आई रिमेंबर वंस हमें एक बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग रिसर्च करना था and they were insistent ke workshops bhi karne. And I hate workshops because there's something so like, udhar jao, 15, aadha ghanta kuch bolo, tasveere khencho. Tasveeron mein har ek ki shakal jo hai brown rangat ki hona zaruri hai. Bahar bachche laga do gareeb gareeb se aur bhej do. Ye our NGO culture, and I have been a part of it. I have been guilty, even though like my team consistently and I, we consistently look at it, okay, how do we want to do this? There are problems in all of that, all of us. I think I understand what you're saying about this need for moral superiority. Main bade upar se aata hun baaz dafa. I'm more in my personal relationships than like, I think overall conversations, because I try to stay away from an individual position. We try to engage stakeholders and like tell stories as an institution. But I agree with you. Ke haan ek masla hai, mera bhi hai, baakiyon ka bhi hai. Unko label kiye bagair ke raaye ko properly samajhne ke liye thoda sa mauka dena padega. On the other hand, obviously, I also understand that there's a lot of anger. There's a lot of anger in young people right now who have not been heard, who have not been seen, who when they've talked about being harassed are not believed, who have a lot of trauma, unprocessed trauma, and who continue to be jinki baat baar baar kaat kaat ke mujh jaise log hi unko sunne bagair zyada bolna shuru ho jate hain. So ultimately, the first person that I would look into in this all, it sounds like I'm such a like wise, like, main sabse pehle apni galti sunta. But ideally, the first person that I want to see is, okay, what role am I playing in this cycle of not having a conversation? Those people are playing a role, yes. Agar unhone mujhe padha aur kaha ki ye to bhai deobandi extremist lag raha hai mujhe bhai, isne to Hanafi riyasat bana deni hai. Let's say that's what they believe about me. And I want to know, what part am I playing in that as well? And I do want to critique them as well. But at the end of the day, however, there's something inherently off about, because a lot of these references mere upar se sar se jayenge, because main Twitter se dur rehta hun. But whenever I open up Twitter, obviously the platform is extremely toxic. Like I remember main Dr. Nita Kirmani se bol raha tha ki bhai, main to do jumle bhi aise sun lu to main to seedha dysfunctional ho jaunga do hafte ke liye.
I have no idea how Nida has so much patience. Dr. Nida ki itna patience samajh nahi aata mujhe.
And so yeah, and so many women, I was telling like my we were having a conversation, so we have this sensitization project about gender and harassment, and women were telling their stories, and I was like, yaar agar ye mere saath ho, mere andar nahi hai himmat yaar. I mean, partly, so I'm not trying to like make it romanticize something, and I'm not trying to put myself down. It's just that I've never experienced it. And because I've never experienced it, I don't have a thick skin. The kind of things that these women hear, that they don't have, they must not, they should not hear. So I'm not trying to say, oh, but resilient baat hai. I'm trying to say, whatever way they manage to do that, unko bhi thoda margin milta hai. To be knee-jerk.
Unko to sare margin milta hai. I was just talking.
Margin milta hai.
Maybe I was talking to the left more, because I think they'll listen a lot more to this podcast than the
no,
right.
No, you're
varna,
right.
Varna right ki to yeah. Ye strategy hai. Journalist jo bhi ho, uski 20 saal ki credibility ho. Aap ek dafa raw agent bol dein. Right ki to ye strategy hai hi hai. You're done. It's just ye to raw. Pura channel, Geo Dawn, agar aap, let's say, do bade idare hain, Jung, Dawn. All you need to say is, ye dono raw funded hai. Khatam. Ab Dawn. Yeah.
Absolutely. And abhi bhi hamare samne ho hi raha hai ye sab kuch, but I do think and this is not necessarily in response. I think your point still stands. There are people out there who are not going, who I remember people telling me something about, I don't know who it was. It was stupid. I mean, as much, I've worked with Jibran for a long time, Jibran Nasir, and we've worked together on multiple issues. I have disagreements, I have agreements, the way everyone has. And when someone comes in and it's like, usko Iran fund karta hai. And I was like, ek second, like, my no, can make, but okay, but how did you reach there? So I know, and they were very progressive about it. And they came from a place of, they were offended by something, and then karte karte karte, and they were the left se the wo. And there are people out there, obviously, because at the end of the day, hum sare insani fitrat mein hi shayad ye strongmanship hai aur reductionist hona hai, chahe aap पैदा एक प्रोग्रेसिव खानदान में हुए हैं या फिर उधर हुए हैं आप, एट द एंड ऑफ द डे कुछ तो सिमिलैरिटीज मिलेंगी. बट आई थिंक अगर हम सॉल्यूशंस और इंटरवेंशंस की बात करें, आई एम रियली ऑफ द ओपिनियन दीज डेज दैट हमें कहानियां बताने की जरूरत है. वी नीड टू टेल स्टोरीज, वी नीड टू टेल ऑल काइंड ऑफ स्टोरीज एंड कम्युनिटीज. You know, we've been saying women need to tell their stories, but also religious communities, jo minority communities hain, unki leadership emerge honi nahi paari organically. So Martin Luther King could make that call ki hum march karne ja rahe hain because he represented the stakes of for the black folks. Malcolm X was from that community. Mujhe yaad padta hai, main ek bahut influential important bande se baat kar raha tha, jo keh raha tha ki le to jaoge Supreme Court, ठीक है जजमेंट भी दिलवा देना, बट गांव तुम्हारा नहीं जलेगा, बस्ती तुम्हारी नहीं जलेगी. अगर कल को फैसला आता है जिसमें सुप्रीम कोर्ट कहती है कि कानून तौहीन रिसालत के अंदर ये और ये मसला है, एंड एज पर द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन फंडामेंटल राइट्स एज वेल एज कुरान सुन्ना के खिलाफ है, देयरफॉर दीज थिंग्स आर स्ट्रक डाउन, तो अगले दिन जब वायलेंस होगा तुम शायद इंडिविजुअली मारे जाओ, बट कम्युनिटी वाइज तुम्हारी कम्युनिटी कुछ नहीं होगा. सो हाउ मच रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी आर यू विलिंग टू टेक for those communities. So we need stories to come, human stories to come in all forms, from women, from the marginalized community, from the religious communities, and those leadership that we are seeing now from women to also happen from religious minority communities as well. From ethnic communities humne dekha hona shuru ho gayi, Balochistan se nikal rahi women, but I also want that to happen more, not in an NGO form. So we have great Christian community leadership in the past, WB Peter Jacobs saab wagaira hain. But no, I'm talking about people that come up as activists. We need their stories, their voices, so that they can decide, they can really address it. Right now, whenever I talk to someone from the Christian community, they're like, bhai, sahi hai bhai, kanun sahi hai, hone do, har koi ek dusre ki izzat kare, hume kuch nahi karna uske saath. So aap bhi jo hai na, usse duri rahe. Most of the time, that's the answer I hear. Not because they're not affected by it, but because in every way, they're so repressed. That they're like, let that system of oppression stay where it is, warna hum mare jayenge beta, zyada hero banne ki koshish na karo, easy ho jao.
And that's valid.
So we need that too. It is.
And it's their story to tell. Listen, I mean, if you've seen some of the podcasts, आज भी हमारी, मैं नहीं रिस्ट्रिक्ट करता जिसको जो बात करनी है, इट्स अ फ्री प्लेटफॉर्म. अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम पीपल आर लाइक, व्हाई डोंट यू इनवाइट क्रिश्चियंस एंड हिंदूज. आई वाज लाइक, आई हैव कांटेक्टेड अ बंच एंड All of them have said, yeah, we're not comfortable. And that's their story. Main force to nahi kar sakta kisi ko. If they don't want to talk about it, if they want to prioritize their safety, that's fine. It's their decision to make.
Yeah, so the question then becomes, the same way, how do we create space for women? How do we create safe space for women? How do we create safe space for minority communities? Like, how can we then create a space where they feel like they can talk, that we have their backs? What would that look like? Because ultimately, the change leadership cannot be me. It has to be from those communities who are being affected first and foremost. Because you are 26 times more likely to be affected by the blasphemy law if you are non-Muslim. People keep saying ke zyada cases Muslimano ke khilaaf hue hain. Well, thoda sa SAT ka test bhi kya mathematics hoi thi padhli hoti. 96% मुसलमान अगर हैं, सो रेशियो एंड प्रोपोर्शन लगा लें, थोड़ी सी मैथ्स कर लें, स्मॉल प्रोपोर्शन ऑफ द कंट्री फेसेस, एंड ऑब्वियसली दैट्स नॉट इवन टेकिंग इनटू कंसीडरेशन एक्स्ट्रा जुडिशियल वायलेंस. सो अ बिग रोल नीड्स टू बी प्लेड, एंड आई डोंट नो द आंसर्स टू दीज क्वेश्चंस. आई हैव पोस्ड मोर क्वेश्चंस देन आई हैव गिवन आंसर्स, बट आई फील लाइक दीज आर थिंग्स टू रिफ्लेक्ट ऑन हाउ डू वी बिल्ड दिस नेटवर्क्स. दिस माय बिगेस्ट थिंग, स्टूडेंट्स आर इनक्रेडिबल. द स्टूडेंट्स दीज डेज आर इनक्रेडिबल. Every A-level ka bacha who has come in with his gap year, ya first year se koi bacha alum se ya GC se FC se internship karne aaya, I am looking at him like, yaar jab main iski umar mein tha, mujhe bas guitar bajana tha, and like mera maksad tha ki bas main paise bana lu taaki main jo hu na wo army wali mein jo beti hai na unse shaadi kar sakun. Like ye mera height thi of things, right? Music was self actualization for me, fair enough, which can be, I'm not looking down, but I'm saying these kids, they're ambitious, they're intelligent, sometimes they're a bit arrogant, I'll take it. They're really sensitive to what's going on. And some of these student communities, student federations, they are really trying to create networks. So I have a lot of hope over there as well, that these undergrad students, की छोटी छोटी जो उन्होंने बनाई हुई हैं societies that are pretty inclusive, and then they do these things where they go to these communities and do this work, on ground work. I hope somehow people like you and I, we can assist them in that. And I think, dekho, I am very hopeful about, let me think about this. Yeah, I am. I am very hopeful about the future of this world and this country. If I weren't, I would just go and do something else. I just make more money, have a good life, decent life, do something else and enjoy it. The reason we have the whole team, we have a fire in our belly and we are willing to tell stories is not because hame koi thrill chahiye, excitement chahiye, but it's because we believe not only is that this is a fight worth fighting for, but also it's a fight that is possible to win. And it is a fight. It's just a matter of what does resistance mean right now? Iske various forms ho sakte hain. Liberty Chalk pe bhi resistance ho sakti hai, press club ke samne bhi ho sakti hai, social media ke samne video bana ke bhi ho sakti hai, elections khade ho ke bhi ho sakti hai, filmmaking mein bhi ho sakti hai. I guess Twitter pe bhi ho sakti hai. That's where my cynical voice comes in. But like, I guess ho sakti aur hoti hai. Good things have also happened there. What does resistance look like? What does long-term resistance look like? For everything, for climate change, for liberty, for everyone. What do we want our state to look like beyond this secular and theocratic state wali binary? What do we want our future to look like? This time it's us. Agar hum bolte hain na, hamari previous generation really screwed us over. They handed over us a country with jisme climate change pe koi kaam, climate pe koi kaam nahi hua, jisme blasphemy law jaisi cheezon pe missing person, institution ki separation, democratization, education, health. Now it's our turn. And I think resistance ko define karna, apni kahaniya batana, starts with that, connecting with each other, what you and I were doing, this is part of that. Just saying it as it is, yeah.
Jitne hum layers peel karein, bade hum basic chimp, ape type log hain sare, insaan. And even a lot of the issues we've discussed, they really boils down to tribalism. Ki aapne jis tarah kitab ki bhi baat ki, printing press ki, it literally was that they saw one book by probably the worst individual in that community, and wo jo chimp mind nahi hota, jis tarah purane tribes mein agar dusre tribe ka person looks different than you and you've encountered that person, now every person that looks like that person for you is forever shaped and colored by your experience with that individual. So jis tarah printing press ki bhi aapne baat ki ki agar aapne ek kisi fic ya kisi sect ki kitab padh li, and that's inflammatory and it's terrible. हर इंसान जो उस फिक का है या उस बिलीफ सिस्टम का है, अब वो कलर हो चुका है. और ट्विटर पे भी इस तरह है कि आपको एक मिल जाए, एक आपको कोई लेट्स से शिया स्कॉलर मिल जाए जो गलत बातें करते हैं या इन्फ्लेमेटरी बातें करते हैं, यूल स्टार्ट थिंकिंग एवरी सिंगल शिया पर्सन दिस इज व्हाट देखा, ये देखो.
Which is why representation is so important, because so that we know not only that के one person, that they're no monolith.
Yeah.
We don't like to be called monoliths. Jab hum America jaate hain, toh phir all of a sudden we want to be not be painted in one brush. The same way, you're absolutely correct. And I agree with you partially about the tribal part as well. But you're absolutely correct in saying this, ke log, we need conversations that go beyond ke ek bande ki baat suni and you aapne natija nikal liya. Community aisi hai, because that's especially with the Ahmadi community, because of the 1953 ke baare mein Kasmi sahab ko jab bulayenge aap to 53 pe wo jab batayenge aapko,
unhone ye shart rakhi thi, unhone bola pehle aap aayenge, unhone bola aap se pehle nahi aayenge,
waqai
he said if Arafat will refuse then I'll come, otherwise ask him first. I said theek hai.
नहीं यार 53 पे उनसे ना, आई मीन ही व्हाट अ बुक, एक तो व्हाट अ टेक्स्ट,
व्हाट अ पर्सन आल्सो, कास्मी साहब इज लाइक
या जेम ऑफ अ पर्सन, जेम एब्सोल्युटली ग्रेट गाय, आसिम बख्शी, देयर आर अ लॉट ऑफ दीस पीपल, सम ऑफ देम आर नॉट दैट वेल नोन हु आर लाइक अ रिपोजिटरी ऑफ नॉलेज.
आपने मुझे पूरे साल की पॉडकास्ट गेस्ट लिस्ट दे दी है, मैं नाम सारे लिखता जा रहा हूं, एंड आई एम गोना स्टार्ट ईमेलिंग देम फ्रॉम नेक्स्ट वीक.
ओ हां हां, बुलाएं आप अमर नासिर साहब को, बुलाएं देवबंद के हैं, He's very interesting. He's a really interesting guy. I'll tell you what. Gujranwala mein, his father is Mufti Zahidur Rashti. He runs the Madrasa Jamia Nusratul Ulum. He's been given the Sitara-e, one of the Imtiaz, and he's a very, very important guy. His son, Ammar Khan Nasir, is a Deobandi Alim Fazil, then became a student of Javed Ghamdi, then enrolled into an MPhil, then did his PhD locally, is working with Dr. Ibrahim Musa, jo Notre Dame wale hain, but at the same time practicing as a Deobandi scholar. He's a hybrid of things and people, and he has really interesting positions about things. You will find him to be sexist, but you'll find him to be incredibly creative with the way he resolves blasphemy crisis and the way he looks at the Israel-Palestine issue. He has some really interesting positions. Most importantly, very good logician. You'll have a great time talking to him, Ammar Khan Nasir.
Put me in touch, and if you know
him. I'll send you his number. Yeah, I know him very well.
Again, jitna simplistic lagta hai, these conversations really, really help. Like, jis tarah humne stories ki baat ki, ke ye tweets jo hai na, ye media mein galat hai. 244 characters hai, aapko kisi ke bare mein kya hi pata chal jayega. Mujhe kisi ne aaj message kiya, ke why do you ask for questions? Your guest today posted something on Twitter and then somebody posted something against you. I was like, what did somebody post against me? Phir main ja ke dekha, kisi ne badi shikayat ki hui thi. अब मुझे नहीं पता कि क्या किसका एक्सपीरियंस था. उसने नजर में पेंट कर दिया कि शहजाद तो ये मॉन्स्टर है. व्हाई वुड यू गो टू हिज पॉडकास्ट.
या
आई डोंट नो व्हाट हिज एक्सपीरियंस विद मी वाज. आई एम होपिंग आई डिडंट कम ऑफ एज अ मॉन्स्टर. पर द मोर कन्वर्सेशंस यू हैव एंड द मोर द लेस यू रिलाई ऑन 244 कैरेक्टर्स टू डिफाइन समबडी फॉरएवर आई थिंक at least koi sense of community ban sakta hai, at least koi progress ho sakti hai across the aisle koi conversation. You don't have to agree, for instance, and you also grow. Yeah, 2015-16 mein I was hosting an event and they didn't inform me of the guests, and one of the guests was Hamza Ali Abbasi. Us waqt unhone bahut hi gal baatein ki thi. I said main to announce bhi nahi karunga, I'm going to walk away. Why did you not contract and whatever, and now I would have Hamza Ali Abbasi on the podcast and have this discussion. So, yeah. If somebody boxes me and says ki ye to is level pe the ke unka naam tak nahi lenge, yeah, maybe I was a little younger and a little angrier, a little more bleeding heart. But now I've grown. I'm not that person.
I mean, I don't remember the handle, but there's someone who seems to like my work, and he said something about that thing, and maine bhi message nahi kiya. I would message him ke like talk, tell me what it's about and talk to him about it as well. But I agree, so I don't know what the verdict, quote unquote, in the just court of people on that is. But I do know one thing. I know ke jab maine the ultimate feature film that I want to write, uska jo antagonist hai wo bhi main hu, uska jo protagonist hai wo bhi main hu, because I do know that I have said sexist things. I've done sexist things. There is a sexist human being inside of me. I know that bhi bahut time par hai before I can even start saying ki ha ab jo hai na, like, theek hai, thoda main easy ho sakta hun. There's a lot of learning to do, especially for someone like me who's grown up in a house where very principled patriarchy exists karti hai, not hypocritical, where it's very principled, and you believe that, and you believe in the idea of patriarch, and you believe in an idea of honor in a particular way. And I keep telling these stories to every guy that comes to our office when we're talking about gender. Okay, when I was a young kid, right now anyone who looks at me, unko lagta hai ki yaar ye to main socha tha maulvi hoga, ye to pata nahi kya hai, ye to like he's hugging women and he's just like ye kya scene hai. And then I sit them down and like we talk about things, and one would imagine if someone knows me well that I have strongly feminist politics. But the same guy that has those feminist politics and wants to learn more, when he was 19, I remember my partner at that time got a haircut, and she was from LGS, I was from Crescent. Main Jamiat se abhi naya naya nikla tha. I am seen anything beyond Iqbal Town. Mana tha hamare ghar se, mere parents Bangladesh se, East Pakistan se migrate karke aaye the. There was a lot of fear you don't go to places you don't belong to. And all of a sudden, किसी debating society से बात शुरू हुई थी, and I met that this incredible woman, and I fell in love. And then one day, she told me that she got a haircut, and I was like, oh great. And then she was telling me and that person, and then she said, and then he made sure that the hair was like, मैंने कहा he? She's like, yeah. It's like, a man touched your hair? She's like, yeah, he's an uncle who used to cut my mom's hair and cut my hair. And I was like, okay, okay. And then after the conversation was over, I was heartbroken. Like for, I remember like music lagaya, maine ghante baith ke grieve kiya. And like mera dil mein na, pata nahi dard ho raha tha mujhe ki ye kya, ye kaise ho sakta hai? As if pata nahi kya ho gaya. Ek us teenager ki ana or securities and insecurities and worldviews were defined by the 19 years that he has lived before and by the mother and the father that he has seen. And he was looking for his mother in his wife, in his partner as well. And I remember if at that point, the response I had received was, dude, dafa ho jao, check your privilege. I don't think I would have learned. The way I was dealt with very firmly, but also very kindly, is the way I learned ke, oh, this was about me. This wasn't about her. And that part is about her and has nothing to do with me. That was my first lesson in agency. And when I tell these to my team, sometimes, especially new ones, I know like our next CEO, Rasti, who's the second in charge, she incredible leader. One day she'll be on this podcast and telling these stories much better. She's tired of me telling these stories, but I think it's very important because a lot of kids who come in look up to me, interns who look up to me, I tell them this. Because I tell them, if you find someone who does something like this, don't write them off.
Yeah.
Because this was, I mean, I didn't, obviously, I'm not if I were by nature a controlling type, I would have gone one step ahead and said, don't do it. But by nature, I wasn't a controlling type. But I had experienced betrayal. It was a very, that was my truth and I felt pain. It was real. And hasi bhi aati hai, lekin samajh bhi aati hai. And if you have experienced that, then you start understanding ke, yes, people do have the capacity to grow. Don't let people get away with things without consequences when they have done things which have created consequences, yes. But as far as beliefs are concerned, as far as expressions are concerned, allow people to grow, yes. Give people the room to grow. I've learned that at least in my end, that I have been surrounded. And I don't think I've learned a lot from men. And I don't think I've learned a lot from universities, institutions. I've learned so much from my mother, kindness from my mother, emotional intelligence from my ex-wife, strength from all these employees and peers around me. And most of them have been women. They've taught me so, so very much. And I think it's because they're marginalized that they tend to be more creative. They know how to navigate these things. And I continue to learn so much from women. I don't know hum ye baat idhar tak kahan tak pahunchi, but it's just something that I think jo nikalna chah rahi thi.
Bahut zaruri hai. Aapne jo ye baat ki hai, sach mein agar bataun aapko sir, ke 95 to 99% Twitter pe jo insaan kisi aur ko bura bhala kehta hai, it's not about the other person. It's about yourself. If I look at somebody and I'm like, oh, that person's fat and ugly, and I put that out into the world, I'm the one who feels fat and ugly about myself, or at least I'm conscious about my body, which is why I'm putting out that energy. So most of the people who are just plain hateful on Twitter is because they're hating their life. Because kabhi kabhi mujhe bhi is tarah ki cheez aati hai, mujhe sense hi nahi banta. Like for instance, somebody is like, Shazad is anti-LGBTQ. I'm like, जिस तरह आपने डॉन की बात की, 2013 में मुझे एक्सप्रेस ट्रिब्यून पे मैंने आर्टिकल लिखा था और हमजा लियाबासी से भी मेरा इख्तलाफ इसी बात पर था. एंड आई रोट अ प्रो LGBTQ आर्टिकल 2013-14 एक्सप्रेस ट्रिब्यून में. एंड एक्सप्रेस ट्रिब्यून को अगले दिन बॉम्ब थ्रेट आ गया था. क्रेडिट टू एक्सप्रेस ट्रिब्यून, दे डिडंट टेक द आर्टिकल डाउन. बिलाल लखानी, क्रेडिट टू हिम, ही टुक ऑल ऑफ द फ्लैग. उसने ऑथर का नाम हटा दिया. सो आई सॉर्ट ऑफ जो हैशटैग हुए वो उसके खिलाफ हुए. उसके बाद इवन ऑन दिस पॉडकास्ट, आई मीन द अमाउंट ऑफ पीपल आई हैव हैड ऑन, तो
या
इज नॉट अ एंटी LGBTQ बोन इन माय बॉडी. एंड ठीक है, मैं मेनस्ट्रीम नहीं हूं, बट जितना भी मेनस्ट्रीम हूं, very few people publicly come out as much as me and say this and repeatedly have people and have these conversations. तो इस तरह का जो criticism yeah. आता है, मैं जितनी भी self awareness कर लूँ, I'm like ये तो मेरे अंदर है ही नहीं कहीं से. तो अगर आप ये कह रहे हैं, maybe you need to think about what your thoughts are on the issue.
I feel you. I mean, there's only so much. I mean, वो फिर उस unhealthy हो जाता है कि हर चीज़ में आप पहले अपने पर शुरू कर दो कि शायद एक हड्डी मेरे अंदर है अभी भी जो देखनी है. There are certain things that very crucial to your identity that you've worked hard on. If someone tells me now that you know, okay, you are this. And that particular this is something that I hold very dear to as my identity, and I've worked really hard to get to. So obviously, I would want more than you or this. I would want ke bhai baat karo mere saath. I'd be offended. I'd be hurt because you are almost erasing my identity, because partly how I may be identifying as might be XYZ, and you're saying you're the opposite of that, and maybe partly what you have been identifying as an ally of the community. And someone saying ke ye, and it feels like, ek second, baat to karo, what are you talking about? So I hear what you're saying, and that doesn't mean
ke aapne agar work kiya to aap perfect hain, theek hai? I try and be an ally. Do I have the potential to say something sexist? Absolutely. Can I do something tomorrow which I don't realize is misogynistic? Absolutely. I think what speaks to you as a person is when somebody calls you out and you genuinely feel that, how you react to that. That says a lot more about who you are than making a mistake.
Yeah, blasphemy bhi yahi hai na. People say something offensive. Tum ye socho. The thing about, it's more about someone else than it is about you. Let's say someone's name Sajjad and he said something. He threw a card and the card has Muhammad written on it. It's a real case. Trash bin mein card chala gaya. Is it about him or is it about the person who saw it? Move beyond that. Case register ho gaya. Kisi blasphemy case ka. People are so curious to read ke actual blasphemous statement kya thi. Mere samajh mein nahi aati ke agar tohin amez khake, tohin amez likhaiyan, expressions aapke liye, aapke deen ke liye, aapki iman ke liye itna galat hai, to kyun थाने में घुसे हुए हो, ट्राइंग टू गेट, उसने बोला क्या था ये तो बताओ, बोला क्या था आसिया बीबी ने, आई वांट टू नो क्या है. देयर इज समथिंग परवर्सली, आई बिलीव, एंड देयर इज नो क्लेम टू इट. आई रिमेंबर माय एक्स वाइफ हूज अ साइकोलॉजिस्ट यूज्ड टू से इट्स वेरी सूडो साइकोलॉजी, बट देयर माइट बी समथिंग टू इट. देयर इज समथिंग फ्रॉइडियन टू इट. देयर इज सम परवर्स प्लेजर दैट दे गेट आउट ऑफ सीइंग समथिंग दैट ऑफेंड्स देम एंड देन बीइंग वायलेंट अबाउट इट. Why are people like Hebdo ke cartoon dekhne hain, usne dikhao to sahi, forwarding isne ye bola hai, FIR ke thane mein pata karna chahte hain usne bola kya hai mujhe batao. Partly sure, I can understand they wanna know the gravity of what happened, but more than that, this perverse curiosity says something about you. Maybe your need for excitement, maybe you're depressed, maybe you need something dramatic to happen to make sense of life, maybe you enjoy mob violence, they do, whatever it is, whatever chemicals are going out of your brain the moment you see, oh, usne ye bola hai, and that makes you feel alive in an otherwise dead life, then it's about you.
There's also the case where kisi Christian ne Allah misspell kar diya tha kisi paper mein, exam mein.
Oh, wow. Yeah, I'm not surprised. I mujhe case file aayi thi, jai namaz ka rukh dusri taraf tha, and the person was saying ki yahi hai, and उसने केस कर दिया. केस बना 295A का, जो कि तौहीन रिसालत का नहीं है, तौहीन मज़हब का है. एंड ऑब्वियसली इधर तक की बात रिडिकुलस है, बट जिसने केस करवाना था वो मदरसे में गया, उसने फतवा निकलवाया कि नहीं, ये तौहीन रिसालत भी है क्योंकि ये कॉन्सेप्ट ही नबी लेके आए थे, एंड वो पर्चा कट गया. एंड सो रिडिकुलस, लाइक आई मीन, देन जस्ट हर चीज सी के अंदर काट दो यार. अगेन दोस थिंग्स, व्हाट इज हैपनिंग, दैट आइडिया, एज आई सेड, of language and expression, when you allow infinite meanings to hold gustakh and you allow only one meaning to be held in ishq, I don't think we can expect anything but violence of all kinds, not just physical, to exist in the society as it does. And the intervention we need is to embed back looking at the past, starting off with embed back through music, through poetry, through dancing, through looking at other Muslim communities, through academia, to to recreate the breadth of what Ishq meant. Because academically, there's this idea called University of Virginia research on value predicate analysis. And it says, agar ek lafz ke matlab 5 se 6 ho, that is the best for a civilization. I'm being incredibly reductive, so apologies for the author, to the author. And it's a beautiful research, 15-16 saal ki. And us to phir wo muashra baat cheet kar paata hai, progress kar paata hai. Jitne kam hote rahe utni masle hain, aur jitne zyada hote rahe aur utne masle hain. So ye ishq ke andar kuch maini wapas dalna, that's partly what we want to do with the documentary. And is ghazi is gustakh ke breadth ko kam karna, which is partly what we're kind of commenting on with the film Swipe, which will the film that we're going to release a teaser for very soon as well, is what we're trying to do. And that, I think, is partly the solution as well, to not be embarrassed to say. The biggest reason, Shahzad, that I started doing this was because I love the Prophet. That's it. Because I felt it in my heart. I felt like, ye kya ho raha hai in his name. And for there was a time jahan pe mujhe kehte hue thodi sharam aati thi, because I was surrounded by people who had, I mean, I care for human rights and I care for my community. I care for these people. I care for this mitti. I care for my people. I care for my identity. But sabse pehli instinctive thing came from ishq. It came from love. Main aashiq-e-rasool hoon. Ab mujhe bolne ka ye haq de de, ya to main cheenunga ye kehne ka haq. Agar nahi denge to. Wo cheenne ke tareeke dhoond raha hoon. Ke main aashiq-e-rasool hoon. And you're no one to tell me that I'm not that. Because historically speaking, is tarah ke hi rahe hain aashiq-e-rasool. Aap, as you said, Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan se Imran Khan jo phir se bulwa raha tha.
But yeah. You don't need a license from them. If you feel it,
I don't.
You're one.
I mean,
you're one.
Yeah.
You and God and Prophet aur baaki log jo ek dusre ke mazhab aur unke beliefs mein samajhte hain ki ye unki jagir hai. It's not. It's between you and your God,
yeah.
Your Prophet.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree. I mean, it becomes more complicated when what I mean by allow, when it becomes a force, right? When it becomes violence. Ke, are you trying to say ke tum, you can do this, and this and be an ashik? It's a very violent idea for these people as well. So I'm not saying ke permission ki, I'm saying ke main to bolta hu. Ab to main bolta hu. Pehle main baat kiya tha human rights community ke andar, mujhe lagta tha baaz dafa ke mujhe secondary motivations bata do, but instinctive baat kahun ke na kahun, ab main khul ke bolta hu. But I do think ke thoda na, even I, that's why I love Sarmat Khusat's idea about it, because he complicated his character. I mean, censored film, and I mean, I don't, jitna mujhe pata hai, but ishq rasool ke jo aashiq hai wo kitna complicated ho sakta hai yaar, wo human hai. Aur so we need that, man, we need that. Hamari siyasat, hamari politics, hamari votes, hamari economics, hamari real estate, hamari sab kuch rasool ke hurmat se connect ho chuki hui hai. Sab kuch ho chuki hai. Itni badi trade unions upon trade unions ke elections ispe hote hain, MNA ke elections ispe ho rahe hain. I mean, PMLN ko badnaam karne ke liye ye bolna kaafi hai ki iske inke riyasat ke andar Mumtaz Qadri ko phansi hui thi to PTI ko vote do, se leke Hafiz Center mein election jeetne ke liye ye PPP ke backed log hain, ye Ahmed, ye inhone Qadiani ko andar na aane ka sticker phaad diya tha everywhere. So we need some ownership back, especially for people who genuinely identify as such, and we need to complicate these things a little bit. It's and identify as things unapologetically, if that's who we are, and is that's partly who we are, because there exists Abida Parveen. She's an ashik. I mean, listen to her, of what she's an ashik of whatever it is. I don't want to call it on her behalf, but listen to her. When I'm listening to her, I'm listening to that spiritual woman who's understood ishq hota kya hai. And that's the kind of society I want to live in, man. With a shit ton of Abda Parveens.
So it's even...
Did you just say any?
What you feel like. So agar aap kehte hain ki ishq aur khuda mein ek ruhaniyat hai. if you stand next to Abda Parveen or she comes, you feel it. You feel this quality that there is a heavenly presence. But an angry man on the street throwing a brick or destroying a temple, you're not feeling that. You're feeling violence. So agar har cheez ka jawab duniya mein love hai aur mohabbat hai, and I'm so glad ke jitna ye cliche sound karta hai, it is love that has brought you to the person that you are. Love has helped you find you who you are. So agar love itna fundamental emotion hai, to khuda kahin na kahin love hai, ishq hai.
ishq hai, and which is why when ishq corrupt hua hai.
तो जब आप फील करेंगे आप इश्क फील करेंगे आप वायलेंस नहीं फील करेंगे आप एंगर नहीं फील करेंगे एंड यू समड इट अप आल्सो ब्यूटीफुली दैट एज अ प्रोड्यूसर आई एंड समबडी हु लव्स नैरेटिव्स आई हेट दैट आई हैव टू एंड यू बीन सो काइंड विद योर टाइम थैंक यू सो मच आई हेट दैट माय क्यूरियोसिटी इज गेटिंग द बेटर ऑफ मी सो आई जस्ट वांट टू स्नीक इन वन लास्ट क्वेश्चन के जिस तरह जिना पे भी एक इल्जाम पे ऊनो का रिटर्न कार्ड मिल जाता है आपको What's your take on potentially blasphemy also having that? If you have a blasphemy charge on somebody and you can't prove it and it's false, to uno reverse card ab aap pe lag jayegi.
No. I'm against it completely. False accusation ki provisions maujood hai, false FIR ki maujood hai. Accusation is different from FIR. So maybe we do need legislation for false accusation in general. Kisi ne social media pe false accusation on blasphemy ki hai. Maybe that needs specific legislation. Although I'm against, hum legislate kar karke mar jayenge. I remember the great Asma Jahangir saying ki har kisi cheez ka hal pe, please don't bring me a legislation. But FIRs go, ki Asia ke khilaf agar FIR hui and false sabit hui, then false FIR ka case banega and phir evidence required hoga.
Yeah.
It's malicious. Not that ke
malicious FIR.
Malicious ka hona, yeah. Aur wo maujood hai already. Section 141, 151 jo bhi hai, it already exists. So sometimes those tools are already there. We need to use them. I don't believe in the death penalty. So like far from that, how can I believe in, you know, that attribution to that is like another blasphemy case against them.
Even if we don't legislate, saying a malicious blasphemy accusation online is punishable. Just having that provision, even agar fine hai, even agar deterrence ho jayegi.
Oh, 100%. So that's what I'm saying. FIR already exists. I don't know what the legality of it. Koi na koi exist. Mere khayal mein karta hoga accusation wise. Agar nahi karta, to phir I think ke bada carefully because speech ko limit karne mein bada careful hona chahiye. Fariha Aziz would agree with me in Karachi if she's listening. You should have her on the pod.
Yes, yes.
One of the most intelligent activists that I know. But yes, if someone accuses someone of insulting the Prophet and or in any way calls for violence, and I would even go as far as saying sirf gustakh nahi gaddar bhi, because both of them call for have association of violence to them, then maybe certain legislation may be required separately. But off the top of my head, I don't know ke already kya ye exist karte hain, but I agree with you. Deterrence is chahiye, paise kya jail mein, jail agar hamara system hai, and I am not someone who does not believe ke jails jo hai nahi hone chahiye, so jails dalo usko thaane, let him have a few years and then come out and not do it. Deterrence is important, yes.
Thank you so much for all the time that you've given. This is probably the longest Zoom podcast I've done, because honestly I can sit here for hours and listen to you. You're articulate, you're brilliant, and you don't have an ego about it, which is very, very rare for a person to be this kind and you know, not have that intellectual superiority jo kuch unfortunately kuch logo mein aa jati hai. It just speaks to your quality as a human being, and that is very rare to find, and I would like to appreciate that a lot. Thank you so much for your generosity, your benevolence, so your grace.
It's really kind of
research
you.
As well.
That's really kind of you. I think, and the credit to that goes to people who've grounded me, and that has been my mother, my ex-wife, and my team. And my team, which is going to say, okay, you didn't talk about Sharad Basum, you didn't talk about Swipe, and I will tell them that would require 4 hours.
When are you free next? we should do one which we just talk about animation, and I'm really sorry to all the people, especially Saad Khan, jinhone ऐसे भेजा था एनिमेशन के सवालों का. आई एम रियली सॉरी दैट वी डिडंट गेट टू एनी ऑफ दोस.
लुक, आई एम गेम. इफ यू वांट टू डू समथिंग जस्ट फॉर एनिमेटेड फिल्म एंड फिल्म मेकिंग, आई एम गेम. क्योंकि it's also a very selfish reason, that part, because I want this to blow up. I want people to see it and watch it because we put a lot of hard work onto it. So yeah, we can sometime do it soon. But your kind words mean a lot to me. I cannot tell you, it means a lot to me. And it is working with a team makes you that. I think that's one of the biggest reason I didn't work alone. Jab main akela kaam kar raha tha to tha mere zehen mein एक खास, और वो कीड़ा है, एग्जिस्ट करता है, बट यू हैव पीपल अराउंड यू हु ग्राउंड यू. इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड आई एम ग्लैड दैट यू सेड दैट अबाउट मी. इट मींस अ लॉट एंड थैंक यू सो मच फॉर हैविंग मी, फॉर थिंकिंग दैट दैट व्हाट आई से हैव सम सब्सटेंस एंड इट बिलोंग्स टू योर प्लेटफॉर्म. थैंक यू.
इट बिलोंग्स टू एवरी प्लेटफॉर्म. आई थिंक इट शुड बी शाउटेड फ्रॉम द रूफटॉप्स. आई एम सो हैप्पी पीपल लाइक यू एग्जिस्ट एंड आई रियली फील इफ वी हैव अ फ्यूचर दैट इज लाइक यू. हाइब्रिड गवर्नमेंट यही होनी चाहिए. जो हाइब्रिड मॉडल है ना, यू आर द हाइब्रिड मॉडल, नॉट व्हाट एग्जिस्ट राइट नाउ. थैंक यू फॉर कमिंग ऑन एंड थैंक यू फॉर लिस्टिंग. वी विल हैव हिम अगेन एंड वी विल डिस्कस ऑल द एनिमेशन टॉपिक्स. थैंक यू. टेक केयर. बाय बाय.